propels them into Atlanta to meet Georgia for the SEC championship. They had a fine season for Arkansas as well at 3-3 and 7-3 overall. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler with Gary Danielson. Jamie Erdahl's down on the field. They don't measure SEC West championships around here in Tuscaloosa. They measure national championships, Gare, and two more hurdles to get to that point where they can
and
play.
And they're not low hurdles. I mean, right. They're going to have to earn these wins. Arkansas and then the Iron Bowl at Auburn. But you're right. It's national championship or it's not a successful season here.
Well, the quarterbacks for these two teams have been successful this year, and they do it very different styles.
They do. Let's start with Bryce Young, and this just in. Pretty good football play, right? I mean, Bryce has just taken the mantle and 33 touchdown passes, and look at that face. He's not even happy, but he really is. He's had a great season, and it's not just his skill. He's followed up. He's a great leader, runs the offense and all the checks. He's exactly what this team needed for 2021.
And KJ Jefferson, on the other hand, a guy I just love watching him play football.
Yeah, at first you look at his size. We saw that early, but he is now a 65% passer. He's got it all, and he's got this Arkansas offense going, especially when he's healthy, and he's healthy today.
A guy that he's going to try to avoid today is number 31 for Alabama. I think he's the best football player at his position in college.
I think he is. I mean, Will Anderson, I mean, the first thing that comes to mind to me, relentless. I mean, look at this guy. Don't be fooled by that smile. When he gets on the field, he brings out fear in anybody he's facing, from the offensive tackle to the quarterback.
He's got that kind of look like Lawrence Taylor used to have for
hey,
you.
Hey, 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 we're not going there. not this time of year at Thanksgiving. Bring back those bad memories. He's a great player, but we've got a different look for Arkansas. Three great linebackers, Bumper Pool, all three almost interchangeable as number one. Hayden Henry, he'll make plays, tackles for the loss, watch him run. And then Grant Morgan, the senior. These three guys, really fun to watch on this defense.
They're usually good as a trio for about 40 tackles a game. Here comes the number two Tide, once beaten, and hopefully headed to Atlanta if they can win today. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by USAA, Rocket Mortgage, Coca-Cola Zero Sugar, and by Papa John's. Pittman's Razorbacks, Nick Saban's Tide just about set to square off. Before we do, we check in the third member of our team, the top shooter on our team, Jamie Erdahl.
Brad, Brian Robinson's high school is just 8 miles south of Bryant-Denny Stadium. As a kid, he worked tirelessly to earn a football scholarship at Alabama. Last year, he was honored on Senior Day as a fourth-year player, but he stood on this field unfulfilled. He never got to show his hometown just how good he can be running the ball at the college level. Today, he was honored once again as a fifth-year senior and a very different player on this team. He sat behind a lot of good running backs, but his number has been called finally. It was advice that Nick Saban gave to him over his time here. Be where your feet are. That got him through some of the hardest times. And not only is Brian Robinson playing, he may become the running back that this team rides down a very meaningful stretch of games.
Boy, that's for sure. 823 yards on the ground coming in. Over 2,100 in his career here in Tuscaloosa. You saw him with his mom and his sisters.
And he stayed, and he's getting those carries. He gets over 50% of the rushing attack that doesn't go to the quarterback, goes to that running back right there, Brian Robinson.
Perfect day for football. Sunny and 65 degrees in a series that is in its 32nd meeting. And 14 straight wins for the Tide over the Razorbacks. The last time they beat Alabama, Nick Saban wasn't the coach here. Alabama won the toss and deferred. Arkansas will receive. And we're underway. And a fair catch called for by A.J. Green. So we'll bring it out to the 25-yard line for the Hogs. And the top Hog on the Papa John starting lineup is the guy we just talked about, K.J. Jefferson, having a great year, captain of the team. Almost 2,000 yards so far throwing the ball, and 17 touchdowns on the year. And the rest of the offense that joins him. And they're going to need some big plays from Treylon Burks, their wide receiver, if they're to upset the Tide today. He's the number one target when they go to the air. And right now, Burks in the backfield, in a full house backfield. And a shotgun, and it's a direct snap. And a pickup of about three for Dominic Johnson. Tide hold him up after he got out to the 29-yard line. Defense for the Tide. Looks like this. And one of the seniors, Vanarian Mathis. Big 312-pounder. A key to that upfront group for the Crimson Tide. Here's Johnson in the open field. Toe-toe holding on for dear life and a big run and out across the 40.
And Ness, if he doesn't make that tackle, it's going to go to the house. The safeties are going the opposite way. And, oh, I don't know if Henry was out of position, but if he didn't come in there and make it, he's gone.
Good start for Johnson. And here he gets to the edge again and got about four more.
And I tell you, this is exactly what Arkansas needed. Sam Pittman told us on Friday. That start against Georgia was disaster. Right. 21 early points. They never got back in the game.
They wanted to start fast, and they have. They've worked it out to the 45-yard line already. And Johnson, whoa, and there's Mathis. They call him Little Phil. His grandpa was a Phil, his dad's a Phil, and he just filled the hole right there.
Comes right across the formation. Oh, just whiffs right there in front from Limmer, number 55. Bo Limmer cannot make it. You think big Mathis is going to take you on with both hands, and he does a swim right over the top. Beautiful play.
Brings up third down. Empty set. The tight end in motion, and Jefferson's going to run it. He's not going anywhere. Will Anderson's got him all wrapped up. Number 31, who we talked about. And it's fourth down.
The one thing Sam Pittman told us about the tackles is you can't set too wide against him. He'll come inside each time. And watch him come inside here. Go out, steps inside, exactly what happened.
So Reed Bauer is going to have to punt it away. Slay Bolden back there at the 10-yard line for Alabama. Gets out of the way as it goes out of bounds on a very good kick. And the Tide will be on offense for their first time when we come back. Bailey Zappi of Western Kentucky, 42. Cantor Mordecai, SMU. And then Bryce Young of Alabama in the number three spots with 33 touchdown passes as we take a look at our Papa John's starting lineup. And it brings us to number nine, Bryce Young, the leader of the Tide. There's his numbers. Season high, five touchdown passes a week ago. And the rest of the offense for the Tide looks like this. And Jameson Williams had a huge game last week. Six catches, three touchdowns, 158 yards. He's their number one receiver as far as yardage. And then Mechie as well. On the other side, so two dangerous wide receivers. Slade Bolden is the third. He's in there right now, but this is Brian Robinson. Jamie talked about on senior day, picking up about three on his first carry. Defensively for the Hogs, we talk about the linebacking core. And this guy up front, when we had them earlier this year, he had three sacks in the ball game that we did, and he is a terror on the defensive line.
Forced two holding penalties as well.
That's right. Here's a quick throw out to Bolden. He's got a first down across the 35, out to the 37.
So the balance here is you look at Alabama and you saw Georgia, who ran the ball and dominated the game. And Mississippi State was 36 for 48 for 400 yards. So I think it's balanced, but, you know, which way do you go here?
Bryce Young is going to go on a slant in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Jameson Williams.
Spread it out. Tight ends on the field. This should have been an easy completion. And Jameson tries to, I don't know, didn't even look like he turned too quick. He just dropped it, right?
Yep. That happens sometimes. Not often with him. Second down and 10. Young Throws the back shoulder, and this one is complete to Mechie across midfield for a first down.
How nice is that? Brian Robinson picks up the blitz. That allows and gives you the time to go back shoulder to the outside against Bishop. No chance. Too good of a throw.
Yep.
That's even good coverage. You can't ask anything more from your corner on that play.
Robinson. Good run. Tough run. Down to the 43-yard line. I asked him yesterday, what's the most improved area of your game, Brian Robinson? I thought he was going to say as a receiver, because he comes in having caught 22, 23 balls, but he said blitz pickup.
Yeah,
he had that on the previous play, as you were talking about.
As this Alabama offense has changed over the years, they actually run about 15% less than back in 15 and 11, the other championship. So you better be able to pick up the blitz. I don't care how good you run, you ain't going out there.
On third down, this guy has been brilliant. Third down and two right here, and this will be Brian Robinson's call. And he's fighting for that first down marker. I don't know if he got it or not. It's going to depend on the spot, and it looks like it might be a good spot.
Grant Morgan got in there. That's what those guys, those linebackers look for, those tackles for losses. Morgan beats him inside, help on the tackle, but not enough.
Right at the line, and it is a first down. Morgan comes in as the number three tackler. He's got 78. That's how many of those three guys put together. Led by Bumper Pool at 100. A little confusion here.
Was the clock not working? I think the game clock.
Game on the offense, 5 yard penalty. The first down.
So Bryce is arguing about this. He's going, the clock wasn't set right or something, because, yep.
And Coach Saban saying the same thing.
The last down. First down, there's no foul for delay of game.
All right. So they were right.
The first thing you do as a quarterback, check out where those, you know, play clocks are, because you got to control it when it gets down to 4 or 5 seconds to get that snap off.
So it's back to the original 39, first and 10. Blitz coming off the edge. Bryce Young gonna go down. That is Trey Williams, who got there first.
I thought it was Eric
Gregory.
Yes, it was. It was 50. I don't mind you thinking that it's 55, because that's who we suspect. But that time, five-man rush, and from the left side, I think that's the guy over here that's going to get it. Gregory's going to get it, going to the outside. And that's been the problem spot for this Alabama offense. Right tackle. They made a change to Damian George, and he gets beat on that play.
Second and 19. Young fires down the middle and got it complete. Jamison Williams back to the 35.
So this is this Arkansas defense. They play eight-man drop. That's too big of a hole. When you're dropping eight and you get that easy of a throw, that's bad defense.
Well, he put some whistle on that one. Third down at six. Now he throws lightly over the middle to Mechie, and he's
just
a little bit
short.
Shy.
Yeah, just short. That's what it should look like. You're giving up pass rush to try to crowd those throws on the back end. And you have to make good throws, which he did on that one, Bryce did to Mechie. And then you got to tackle. And they get it a what, half yard short?
Yep. Alabama 7 out of 10 on the year on fourth down. They got fourth down and that much. And they go with a fullback and an eye backfield. Brian Robinson slipped in the backfield, and down he goes. And Arkansas takes over on downs.
I think, Ness, even if he had not slipped, the penetration from this Arkansas front was too much. They get inside. Linebackers are taking on blocks. That was a great job by Hayden Henry taking on the block, and they blew it up for the stop and saved the first down.
No score in the first 6.5 minutes. Go back to that fourth.
Yes, I usually don't use the blocking icon on this telestrator, but watch Eric Gregory block. Caden Henry block and then Grant Morgan block. They block this play. Watch. Coming down from the outside. Boom! Blow it up. Boom! Take it on. Another one. Three guys taking on that short. They're meeting, aggressively meeting that play on the other side of the line of scrimmage.
Arkansas's first drive. They had it five plays and went 20 yards all on the ground. A.J. Jefferson hasn't thrown yet. They start from the 31. And he dropped the ball on the snap, and he got back on top of it. It's still loose.
Yeah, not yet.
I thought he had it. Alabama says they have it, and they do.
What did Sam Pittman tell us? Self-inflicted wounds.
Boy.
If we can keep away from killing ourselves, lining up offsides, silly penalties, this is as silly as you can get. Dropping a snap right to him, a little bit surprised. I think that snap came before KJ thought it was coming, and he did not handle it. And yes, Stromberg snapped it before anybody on that offensive line was ready. And that's what caught you. See, nobody else moves but Stromberg. And that's that crowd noise that they struggled with at Georgia.
Dallas Turner with the fumble recovery gives it back to the Tide. The 32.
They go on a clap. And remember, Alabama had trouble with the clap at Texas A&M?
Right.
Well, today, Arkansas has trouble here.
Latu, the tight end in the backfield with Young and Robinson. See if they can take advantage of the fumble recovery. Brian Robinson, Trey Williams has got it wrapped up after a short game.
That was an odd one, too. On that play, Bryce Young was looking over on the bench when he clapped on the play. Watch as he's turning around. And he claps looking the other way. Now, you'd think that might be a pass play when he'd do that, try to go long, but that was a little different.
Bolden in motion across the field. Blitz coming. Young going the other way. And incomplete intended for Williams.
Well, there has been success against this Alabama offense with the blitz. Texas A&M was blitzing, gave him a lot of problems on the edge and sacks. And then LSU came in here and blitzed a lot of what they call zero blitz, meaning they don't have any free safety on the field. Everybody's got man-to-man. They got five in man, and they rush six.
And now it's third down and eight.
Might do it again right here. Looks like this guy is the only free guy.
Trio of receivers to Bryce Young's left. Here they come. Bringing the house. Young fires high and complete.
Same thing that was blitz zero. Exactly what we're talking about. You're blitzing everyone and you're forcing your five defenders. Now remember, one of them is usually a linebacker. So they got the back, Brian Robinson. But everybody else is man-to-man and you're just saying, we can get to Kim before he can get the ball off.
And wanting to get something out of that fumble recovery, they'll try a field goal for Will Reichert.
Two great stops for this Arkansas defense.
No doubt. This will be a 47-yard field goal attempt for Reichert. Trying to put Alabama on the board. The kick is perfect. So Dallas Turner's fumble recovery turns into three for Will Reichert. With 7:41 remaining, first quarter, Alabama 3-0. So a four-play, two-yard drive after the fumble recovery, and Reichert hits a 48-yard field goal.
So think about this if you're Arkansas, though. When they went to Georgia, about this time in the football game, they were down 21-0.
That's right.
Okay, so they're looking up and say, all right, we're hanging. All right, we're hanging. But they need a drive back. Bryce Young is going to not miss those passes for long.
This is the second time this year Arkansas has played the number two team in the country. Georgia was number two at the time, and they got throttled in Athens. And now here they are in Tuscaloosa, and they're going to have to handle the ball a little better for number one.
Yeah, the Arkansas offense got off running the football well to begin with, and then Mathis gets the tackle for the loss right there. And that got him behind the chains.
Yeah, that blew him up.
That did. And then the next time they get the football, they fumble the snap when Stromberg snaps it and KJ Jefferson could. It actually got kicked out of his way before he actually got to the ball.
Still haven't gone to the air here midway through the first quarter.
Yeah, and they need to figure out a way to get the ball to number 16, Burks.
He's down at the bottom of your screen, but this is a run all the way for KJ Jefferson, and he got buried. First, Helms came up, and then Mathis cleaned up.
Yep. I don't know which way you'd rather have that. Mathis first and Helms, or Helms and Mathis?
I don't know. It hurts either way.
Good. He actually ran in to Cunningham on the play and then lost all his momentum.
He did get a yard.
Oh,
and now it's going the other way again.
This is the Alabama defense that I think, as they watch Georgia play that great defense, the Alabama defense is going, we have to step it up and look like that. That used to be us. People used to compare defense about the way we play. And now, as you see Dallas Turner unblocked go in there and make that play, another self-inflicted wound by Arkansas, an unblocked player on a run.
Third down and 11. Jefferson's first pass is a dart to Burks, and he got the first down. Well, they found a way to get it to number 16,
and
as Gary said.
You called it a dart, and it had to be a bullseye because he was covered on this play right between two Alabama players. How about that throw?
Now they go with some tempo, but the tempo just got stalled by a flag on the far side.
False start on the offense, number 19, 5-yard penalty.
This is going to get Sam Pittman upset.
Oh, boy. He said to us yesterday, he said, it drives me crazy. And he said, we had an official at practice all week, and every time there was an offside or a false start, he threw the flag. It drove him crazy during practice because they worked on it all week trying to avoid this kind of thing.
Yeah, and first down's so important in these games against these elite defenses, and now it's first and 15 with a self-inflicted wound by Arkansas's offense.
Raheem Sanders in the backfield. Jefferson looking left, looking for an escape now, and fires on the run and completes it. Let's check in with Jamie.
Well, this Alabama defensive line looks a little different this afternoon. That is because DJ Dale was injured during warmups. Our great crew caught this on our cameras as he was headed into the locker room. The team is telling me that he's questionable. It looks like a lower body injury, but nothing official.
Jamie, thanks. We were wondering about his whereabouts, and now we know. Second down at 4. Lob pass. Burks got it. Got the edge, got the first down and into Alabama territory.
So this is what you like from the big man, okay? He's all power, he's got the strong arm, but do you have the touch to make the little plays? And this time, kind of a boot, got a defender right in his face, just touches it right over his head. Watch this, little touch pass right over the head of Braswell.
First down at the Alabama 46. Out of the 40 is Sanders. They'd love to get him in some open field. They call him Rocket.
So
there's Sanders.
No doubt that this Arkansas offensive system was built by Kendall Briers, and it's a hurry up, no huddle, spread them out, the old, you know, Baylor offense. But against Alabama, holding on to the ball is big.
We just got official word. DJ Dale is done for the day. Jamie lets us know. Sanders, yeah, they tried to get him out in space, and that didn't work either. Helms and Harris.
Yeah, and this time, I think it's Will Anderson taking on from the right side of your screen. Takes on the block and pops it to the outside. Latham comes over there, number 62, to block him. He gets really low and takes on that block and spills it to the outside. That's Alabama defense. You watch that right there, setting the edge. That's how you set the edge.
Another third and long. They converted the last one. Here comes a blitz. Jefferson throws it out in the flat. This one's not going anywhere. Going to be a loss of a yard, and it's Henry To'o in on the tackle.
Watch Henry To'o on this middle linebacker right above the center. He comes at the beginning, and he blocks. He picks for the tackle. Tries to chip off, and then he sees the ball thrown, forced back in, and he makes the tackle. When he blitzes, he's just not going over to quarterback. He's trying to set up his own defensive tackle.
Arkansas at least is going to win the field position battle right now if they get a decent punt from Bauer. Last time they only hit it 32 yards. This one's a wobbler that's heading toward the goal line. Will it stay out of there? It will.
Oh, my goodness.
Down at the 2.
I think it landed about the 1. I mean, you talk about backspin.
That is perfect. Last week, he had 23 yards on a fake field goal. Now he does his job beautifully with the backspin. Looks like Gary's 9-iron or something.
I'll take it.
Nick Saban told us yesterday 4 yards on first down is good. They really haven't been that so far. Four or more on first down. Brian Robinson, number four. That's a good first down run.
Yeah, just another different look at how, you know, offenses are measured. And we always concentrate on third down conversions. Well, there's first down conversions, and the coaches and the defenses all say four or more is a first down conversion, and they got it on that one.
Robinson carried it out across the 8-yard line.
Extra offensive tackle in the game right now, and this time we got Randolph, number 85. He's 60 or 85. Now he's 85.
Play fake. Long ball. Got it out to Mechie to the 33 and a first down.
Ness, can you remember yesterday when we were talking about the blitz, what Saban said what we need to do more of when they're blitzing? Seven protectors.
That's right.
Well, that's exactly what they did here. They brought in an extra big guy and produced the time to go one-on-one. If you see people playing man or blitzing you, bring in an extra guy and give the quarterback time.
As Nick said, there's only one guy that can catch it out there, so throw it to the open one.
He did.
25. And he's going to throw it right back to Mechie. Coming the other way. Got a block on the edge. Mechie high steps into Arkansas territory.
Well, the pride of this Arkansas defense, because they play a lot of zone, is they tackle in space. But this time, the Alabama offense outwits them. Good block on the outside. Great job by Brooks, number seven, and that is what sprung it.
Back-to-back throws of 25 yards to Mechie, and now a quick throw this time to Billingsley, the tight end. And Alabama's got something moving right here on their offense.
Yeah, and there's the RPO attack right there. Bryce Young is looking out. He understands that he can hand the ball off or throw the quick stop. This time he says, nope, nowhere to run the ball. Give it a quick first down throw.
To the 30. High snap. Got it down, though, to Robinson. And Robinson, no gain on this one. Stuffed up by Isaiah Nichols. Down to 90 seconds in the first quarter. Alabama with the lead, and Bryce Young this drive perfect for 62 yards. Two to Mechie, one to Billingsley. That's Billingsley in motion on second down and 10. Brian Robinson put a licking on one of those linebackers, Hayden Henry, and picked up about 8.
So really, Alabama has 6 offensive linemen. Here's Kendall Randolph, number 85. Watch what he does. He's an extra tackle in the game. He just folds down that defensive line, and that crushes the play. Good formation use by Alabama, and they're keeping him on again.
Bill O'Brien, the offensive coordinator, told us Kendall Randolph has been our unsung hero this year.
Well, on that play, he was, for sure.
Got it to short yardage, 3rd and 2. Robinson, this time he's got a first down. Took Bumper Pool with him.
Interesting, a little bit of an influence play on short yardage this time. Neil Eckyard, number 55, actually pulls on the play, and then Brian Robinson can read where he wants to go and just cuts it back inside the stunning linebacker. Good run by Robinson.
And a first down in the red zone at the 18. Final play of the quarter if it gets off, and they do. And Robinson will lose a couple to end the quarter.
Penetration, tackles for losses. That's what those guys got to do, and did it well for that Arkansas defense.
End of the first quarter. Hard-hitting SEC West matchup between number 21, Arkansas, number 2, Alabama, and the second-ranked tied with a 3-0 lead. Depot SEC at CBS enters quarter number 2 here in Tuscaloosa. And Alabama with a 3-point lead. They've got it at the 20-yard line of Arkansas to open the quarter. The second down and 12. Hey, Play fake. Bryce Young loads, rips it to the end zone. Touchdown, Alabama. John Metchie. Well, that was the John Metchie drive, Garrett.
Well, I'll tell you this. He went to the right guy. You get one crossing route. Watch all the traffic going this way, and then Metchie gets one-on-one coverage. The ball goes to the right read. Perfect read by the quarterback. Kept an extra tight end and fullback in on the game for protection. Perfect throw. Great drive.
A 98-yard drive and nine plays as Reichard attempts the point after, which is up and good. And of that 98 yards, 70 to that guy.
I said he wouldn't keep missing them. He's not.
Pretty good quarter and one play for John Metchie so far. 589 and one.
And he didn't even practice Thursday. He was out getting his checkup, took a day off, kind of load management.
Yeah, he went to Birmingham to get his back checked.
I might go get my back checked if that helped me play like that.
Here's the first quarter for John Metchie. First quarter plus one.
Yeah, coming off the goal line, I mean, they give good one back shoulder throw to begin the game, and then they get protection. See a lot of man-to-man, keep an extra guy in to block. Little quick screen with great blocking on the outside, and then one-on-one, Bryce goes to the exact guy he should and delivers it where no one else can get it.
And from our AT&T 5G pylon cam, this one's coming right at you with Metchie. Pretty good coverage, but a perfect throw and a perfect route and a touchdown. It is 10-0.
Well, the defense cannot be expected to keep up for Arkansas all game. This offense for Arkansas has to step up now.
Johnson trying to get wide, toe-to-toe, won't let it. No gain. Transfer from Tennessee, Henry Toto, and on the offensive side, smiles all around as Bryce Young just threw his 34th touchdown pass of the year. Jefferson on a slant, incomplete. Looking for a flag, was Warren. He didn't get one.
Yeah. Again, and remember that last bullseye he threw? This would have taken another bullseye. Good coverage by that Alabama secondary, jumping on those short passes right now.
Blake Kern in the backfield actually is a fullback, and now he comes up to his tight end spot. Blitz from Alabama coming. Jefferson incomplete. And again, looking for a flag was Warren, and Jefferson thought there should have been some laundry on the field, too.
Interesting pass rush by Alabama. It looks like a three-man front, but watch how they try to pick for Will Anderson. Inside, 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 and Will Anderson will come around basically unblocked. If you're going to be in the pocket, he'll be there. Teams try to double-team your best pass rusher, you got to come up with pick plays, and that's a pick play for the defense.
I agree with Warren and K.J. Jefferson. I thought that should have been a penalty on Alabama. Nonetheless, it's a Bauer punt coming up.
Ooh, a bit of an angle here. Look at how they line up and kind of angle it to the punter.
And play clock winds down. I don't know if they got a timeout call or if it'll matter. It's delay of game.
Delay of game on the offense. 5 yards to the
Boy, that's another one. If we're going to see, you know, it's nice old smiling Sam Pittman when he's done in interviews. We're going to see the other side of Sam pretty soon, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. So they line up, and now Bauer's back around his own 5-yard line.
Same look with the angled snap.
Slade Bolden waits on the other end at the Alabama 40. Bauer gets it out of there in a hurry. And he takes a pretty good bounce and out of bounds around the 31. That's where Alabama will go to work against Sam Pittman's Razorbacks with a 10-0 lead when we come back. That's not the happy Sam. Game here today, 10-0.
Hot shot Jamie. Basically.
Yep, she does it all. mother of two, basketball star, you name it.
That's what I came here for.
Great line. Talking smack to the football team. Brian Robinson.
Oh, man.
Another tough run of about seven or eight.
Yeah. Barry Odom is kind of, what do you do? Twixt and between right here. He started off the blitz, and I don't blame him. It's not what Arkansas does, but you got to see if Alabama can pick up the blitz. But the counter has been from Bama to bring on an extra tackle and load up and block it.
Little pirouette there by the quarterback, Young. Jameson Williams doesn't get anything out of it. In fact, lost about 3 yards.
Yeah, great job by Ladarius Bishop that time, the corner. He read it fast and broke it up. Beat the block to the outside. Remember, they threw a quick kind of one before, and he got the block on the corner. This time, no.
And it brings up third down again.
Three-man front, but let's see what they actually bring. Is it three or more?
Barry Odom's defense, best in the SEC on preventing third down conversions. Robinson now comes out as a wide receiver.
There's the signal right now that it's man-to-man coverage because the linebacker comes out with the running back. They're coming.
Young down the middle. Mechie on the fly. John Mechie still going. Down to the 32-yard line. Joe Fouché saved a touchdown.
You win at the line of scrimmage. That's where you win. You beat man-to-man quick. Watch the patience. Stutter step, and he wins at the line of scrimmage. Great patience by Mechie to win. He won that route in the first 1 yard.
Picked up 33 yards to the 32. And now the quick throw is tipped at the line of scrimmage. Almost intercepted by Bumper Pool.
Good read that time. It probably was a blitz from the left side. Tried to throw right over the blitz. Now remember, Bryce Young is not the tallest guy, but this time he's got his eyes left. He sees it, and it was actually the corner.
Yep.
Brown that got the tip on the play. Read well by the outside by Mechie, but the jump and the tip made it go.
Tarek Brown, who leads Arkansas with four interceptions, got a hand on that one to break it up. Second down and 10. Young, look out from behind. Now he's going to run. Not big on running, and we got a flag down as well as he picks up the first down, but it might be coming back.
Well, Bumper Pool that time thought he had him, but as he was trying to turn the corner.
On the offense, number 71, 10 yards coming from the previous spot.
And Darren Delcourt's going to get the call. But watch Bumper Pool come around from the left side of the screen. Thinks he's got him, and
nope.
Like eyes in the back of his head.
So the holding call negates that first down run by Bryce Young. Backs it up to the 42-yard line.
Well, right now, Jameson Williams has been quiet. But when he's in the slot, that's the danger spot for Arkansas. That's where he makes his big plays.
Mechie's been the main man today, but Williams is the home run hitter. Young fires and overshot Jameson Williams.
That's when he's dangerous, when he's in the slot, because he can match up against safeties when he's in that slot. The speed too much for those safeties. Watch him. He'll fake the post and then come back out to the outside, and look how open he is.
And Bryce Young just missed him.
You know, one in three of the pass attempts by Alabama go to Mechie or Williams. A year ago, one third of them went to a guy. What was his name?
Devontae's.
Yeah.
Heisman.
I think so.
Trey Sanders in the backfield right now with Young. A very limited supply of running backs for Alabama due to injury.
This will be a three-man rush right here. Back off and force the short completion.
Young on the move, and he's going to keep it again. He has to now. Shoved out of bounds around the 36. Fans don't like the way he got shoved out of bounds, but I don't think it was much more than a little push.
Yeah, that was pretty funny. Coach. Greg Brooks is the guy who shoves him out, but watch me. I don't know how far we go here. After he shoves him, he turns around and kind of looks to see if there's any flags. Kind of as he runs up. Yep, yeah, oh, let me look right here.
And he said, I got to put the brakes on because I don't want to run over Nick Saban.
Exactly. I had to get a flag.
Yeah, I had to get a couple flags, I'm sure. It's fourth down and 14. And
game.
We're going to go punt. It would have been a 54-yard field goal from this spot.
So Burnup will kick it.
That was a great timeout by Sam Pittman. Arkansas had 12 men on the field, and I think if they got the penalty, they would have gone field goal attempt.
Exactly. Good point. So timeout with 11:18 remaining. Fourth down coming up for Alabama. And there he is, Zook on the sideline. As a matter of fact, Bryce Young had a good first half, including his 34th touchdown pass of the year to John Metchie. If we go back to the timeout.
Yeah, a little gamesmanship. Whenever it's on the near hash to the bench, a late substitution by Alabama to punt causes the problems for Arkansas.
This is Alabama's first punt by Burnett. High wobbler, hangs a long time. Plenty of time to just make the catch down there at about the 3-yard line. Another good punt. Each team has had one like that today. Well, they don't break the law, they bend it. Meet the McCluskeys, power brokers in Kingstown, Michigan, where the business of incarceration is the only thriving industry. New drama, Mayor of Kingstown, from Yellowstone, co-creator Taylor Sheridan, features Jeremy Renner, Diane Wiest, and Kyle Chandler. You can stream it now exclusively on Paramount Plus. Saw the trailer for that last night. It looks awesome. So, in a hole, the Arkansas offense, and it's been kind of in a hole through the first quarter and the first 4 minutes of quarter number two.
They haven't stretched this Alabama defense out at all.
Jefferson fires far sideline. Got it. Good throw and catch.
Finally. Alabama squatting on those slants. You've got to throw the ball deep. Even if you don't complete them, you got a one-on-one and you got a great receiver. Now, it's good coverage, but remember the back shoulder throw Alabama had to Metchie? Basically the same thing.
Pick up of 32. Now they go to the ground and a pickup. Treylon Smith, as we check in with Jamie.
Guys, Treylon Burks, that was quite the catch considering he hasn't been on the field in the last couple offensive series. He's in a ton of pain in his right side of his chest area, I would say about the collarbone. They put a couple medical patches on there. He's had a lot of conversations with Kendall Briles, but what a catch considering the pain he's in right now.
Yeah, he was holding that R2, Jamie, exactly after he made that catch. Came up wincing in pain, but staying in there. Second down and 7. Jefferson under center. Gives it to Burks. Now it's an end around and it's a fumble. Scooped up by Warren and he's dropped back at the 29-yard line. That one didn't work.
Well, Arkansas football players know Alabama's good, but we're our own worst enemy here so far in this football game. You're not going to beat this team playing with sloppy play. You've got no chance. That's been practiced probably 100 times. And in the game, you put it right on the ground.
Well, they played the number two team in the country, first Georgia and then Alabama. Nothing to show for it on the scoreboard so far. Jefferson, quarterback draw, had a big open field off the right side, broke one tackle, and he's close. That close.
Is it close enough to go for it? Now I'm thinking in my head as he's running, without the tech mess up of the play, it's an easy first down here. But he almost gets it anyway, and I think they're going to call it a first down. Am I right?
They already moved the chain.
Wow.
I guess they better.
Yeah.
I thought the official on that far side came up about a foot shy.
Well, we're
going to
get maybe a challenge from Nick Saban. Or is the
ruling
replay
on the field is a first down? That play is under review.
Yep. Replay booth's going to take a look.
Yeah, they are. And Nikki Haddock's a replay official. And when that official came up, and you'll see it maybe on this replay, put his foot down, and I thought it was about the length of his shoe, the officials, that is, shy of the first down.
Yeah, but neither one of those looks are going to help. It's from the wrong angle. Nothing so far to help the replay official overrule the call on the field.
Gene Steratore, our rules officials, with us. Gene, I don't know what you can see.
There's
we
one,
can't,
though.
But let us know.
Yeah, I think the line feed right now is the best angle to get. And Branch puts a big hit on KJ Jefferson. We can see. I thought he was short, but it is just the nose of the football that has to make that line to gain. And that is the piece of it that I just can't see definitively enough again to overturn the ruling on the field.
Oh, boy. I think he's like a half yard short here. Big hit by Branch. Turns him, ball's in his right hand, and the official runs up.
That's what I'm trying to say. The official came up and put his foot down and stopped.
I know,
about
but,
right
but
there.
Now I'm just thinking he doesn't have any better view of
no,
it.
No, he's got a worse view.
Exactly.
There he comes.
So he's just guessing.
He
basically
puts the brakes on right there. That's short. And then he moved his right
hand. Then he turned and moved it. He's like a dance step.
Did a Tuscaloosa two-step
right
there at the end of that.
I thought the football was short of the line.
Here's a call.
After review, the runner was short of the line to gain.
Now Sam Pittman has to make a decision.
Yeah, do you want to go on fourth and a foot in your own territory?
You've got a quarterback that weighs 240 pounds. I mean, if Tom Brady can do this, who's not 240 pounds?
Joe Namath here. We could do a naked bootleg with Joe Williams.
Right. Now remember, Arkansas does not take a lot of snaps directly under center.
Right. Arkansas 6 out of 13 on fourth down this year. They send everybody up to the top of your screen. Empty backfield in a shotgun, so 6 yards deep. And now Jefferson will come under center and go straight ahead. And he got it with second or third effort.
You know what's interesting with that call? They did spread him out a little bit, but you get no push with that formation. Nobody, you know, now you're allowed to, from that running back position, come in and hit the quarterback. It was all Jefferson. The numbers did not favor him, but the 240 pounds did.
Will Anderson's holding on, but he's going, well, this guy doesn't weigh 210, though. So first down. Arkansas keeps their drive alive. Jefferson wants to throw. Now he's going to take off. Oh, did he put a helmet into Toto? We brought him down, but he got about 8 yards out of it. That was a collision.
Well, two quarterback runs that looked like passes to begin with have been the running game.
Dominic Johnson. And, oh, man. The 40-yard line, a collision there. And Johnson with the first down run.
So Alabama's defense has only given up more than 100 yards twice all season this year. We saw it in the Florida game.
Yep.
The running quarterback was a big part of it.
Jefferson stands tall in the pocket, rips it down, incomplete, intended for Burks. And broken up by Malachi Moore.
What a great play by Malachi Moore. Playing the star position means he has to cover the slot all over the field. Now watch him cut inside. Get inside, get his hand on him. Could have been caught.
Yep.
His hand on his other arm might have forced the incompletion. That could have been called, I think. He held his arm on that play just like a long pass down the sideline. That might have been the difference.
Second down and 10 from the 40. One-handed catch by the tight end, Blake Kern. That's good job with the left mitt there.
Remember, we were bragging on his touch pass earlier in the game. This was a touch soft. Could have got him a little bit, and his receiver bailed him out.
Traylon Smith in the backfield. They fake it to him. Come out to Burks. Burks swipes one guy away with a left hand and gets a first down.
Well, Traylon Burks is their game breaker. And after Jamie's report, him playing in pain like that, you got to really salute a guy playing big game like that and playing under duress.
And a short game there. Complete to Tyson Morris.
So it seems to me so far the key to both teams' offense is to get the ball backed up on their own 2 or 3 yard
line. Yeah, and then go 98 yards.
Exactly. Bama did it, and now this is a really nice drive by Arkansas. What, 11 plays so far on this drive? And that Arkansas defense needed it badly.
Yeah, they needed a breather. They were out there a long time. 4 out of 5 on this drive for KJ. There's a little shovel to Schmidt. Broke one tackle, got down to the 15-yard line where it's 3rd and short.
This was nice. A lot of misdirection on this play. Two key players going one direction, the ball going the other direction. That's that eye candy that Kendall Byers is trying to put in this run offense for Arkansas.
This is Jefferson all the way, isn't it? Nope, he's going to throw. And he's got his man out in Burks. Broke a tackle and a touchdown, Arkansas. Trailing Burks in the end zone and cuts it to a field goal lead.
Well, you were half right, Ness. It's KJ Jefferson half the way. Beautiful position in the slot, breaking out, and this time a very accurate throw. Malachi Moore does not get picked and doesn't get out there with the right leverage for the touchdown. What a drive by this Arkansas offense.
Cam Little in for the point after. Up and good.
Playing hurt and making plays.
Traylon Burks in the end zone for the 9th time this year. 15-yard scoring strike for KJ Jefferson, and it's 10-7. That injury to Traylon Burks that Jamie reported a few minutes ago is not feeling any better, even though he just caught a 15-yard touchdown.
And he used the stiff arm this time, but he used it with his left arm. So he's got a bad right arm or pec muscle or shoulder, but he came through on that drive, didn't he?
Sure did. Much like the Mechie drive for Alabama, that was the Traylon Burks drive. KJ Jefferson with his 18th touchdown pass of the year. Calaruso to kick off, and Alabama will start from the 25 with a 3-point lead. Now it's time for Do Project Smarter, presented by the Home Depot.
Well, when you are getting a blitz, you got to get a hot quarterback because you know it's one-on-one. They make you make good throws, and Bryce Young has been getting good throws because they put an extra lineman out there to take on that blitz. Bill O'Brien, nice changeup for a team that's been struggling with the blitz to put an extra offensive lineman on the field. That should force most more zone coverage from this Arkansas defense because 85 ain't going out for a pass.
Now you see things have evened up, including on the scoreboard, just a field goal difference. Bryce Young comes up ready to throw on first down. Maybe not. He won't. Going to get sacked by Zach Williams.
Well, Damian George, the new right tackle in the game. He's replacing Chris Owens, number 74. Right here's the matchup. Gets pushed back. Good push back. And then as Bryce Young moves up in the pocket, gets the sack.
And a loss of 4. Young. Gonna go long. Man out there. Got him in stride. Jamison Williams, goodbye. Touchdown, Alabama. Touchdown toss.
Well, you said it. A strike. This time, Jamison wasn't in the slot, but he was stacked. A little different look, and he just takes it. Enough protection. Remember, just a 3-man rush. And he goes. Perfect throw right over the safety. And the corner just stumbled, and could not handle the strike by Bryce Young.
As we said, he's the home run hitter. Your point is good. 7th play of 50 plus, and that doesn't include a couple of touchdown on kickoffs. The big play guy had a 94-yard touchdown earlier this year. He just caught a 79-yarder right here between double coverage on a perfect throw from Bryce Young. And just like that, the Tide rolls back in front, 17-7. Another look at our touchdown that last play.
Brown, number 21. The corner is playing outside technique because he has help deep back here, 15 yards deep from the free safety, and Williams runs right by him. The corner thinks he's got help depending on it. When you line your safety up 15 yards deep, you should not get beat deep.
Jameson Williams came in averaging 20 yards a catch. He's not hurting his average any today so far, with three grabs for 89 yards and a touchdown. Time right now to test your knowledge with today's trivia question, which is, in Nick Saban's head coaching career, who was his first player to be a first-round NFL draft pick? Kind of a tough one, actually.
Hint? Can I give a hint?
You would think maybe it was at Michigan State, but
the key part of it was head coaching career.
Right. That's right.
That's the key phrase.
Well, as he stalks the sideline right now, he's won 64 of his last 67 games on this field. He's got a 10-point lead right now with 5:20 to go to halftime. Burks playing in pain, still in there circling in the backfield, but it's Smith up the middle, and he almost busted it. A shoestring tackle by To'oto'o.
That's the second shoestring tackle To'oto'o has made in the game. To the outside he goes, and then he gets back in on the play.
They go right back to him, and he does the same thing again. Traylon Smith out to the 47.
That's what happens when you go this hurry up tempo offense. You repeat plays, and that was a good repetition on that one.
Oh, I guess.
Gonna go fast again.
They fake it to Smith. Jefferson stands tall, rips it down the sideline. Another first down at the 36. And that's Trey Knox, the tight end slash wide receiver.
Yeah, he's listed on the card as a wide receiver, and he plays, lines up in the tight end position.
Perfect throw. Arkansas moving in a hurry. Smith with a stiff arm. Keeps his balance. Picks up good yardage. Down to the 31.
You know, so all of the talk about KJ Jefferson when the season started is this guy's a runner. This guy, 240, he's going to run this option downhill. You know, if he comes in this game, he's 11 for 14 going into this game. And he's been hot lately, too. He was 19 for 23 against Mississippi State in their winning win.
And he didn't turn it over. This one he's got to throw on the ground. Burks was the closest guy.
Yeah, that snap was low. Nothing was really nice about that play. Again, kind of a little bit of a mess up to begin with. Low snap, goes down, and then by the time he gets it off, perfect coverage by Alabama.
On the offense, number one, that penalty is a loss of down at the spot of the foul.
They call grounding.
I thought he was throwing it right at number 16.
That's what Sam Pittman thinks, too.
Yeah, I thought this was pretty good, and he could have been outside the tackle box on the play as well. I think that's a tough call. I'd really like to get Gene's opinion on this. I mean, that's a tough call on a quarterback. Throws it right at the feet of a receiver, and he's on the edge of the tackle box.
Gene, what do you think?
Now, I agree with Gary on the play. Look, we know that he's throwing this ball away, but with somebody in the area that close, you give them the benefit of the doubt and just play the next down. Totally agree with Gary's interpretation on that.
Well, the next down is 3rd and 13 with the loss, 3rd and 14, actually. So what was a great-looking drive might stall unless Jefferson can hook up with somebody. Going deep, and he's going to hook up with somebody. Touchdown, Arkansas. Warren Thompson.
Warren Thompson wins right at the line of scrimmage.
It's a flag down.
That penalty is declined. The result of the play is a touchdown.
Watch Thompson win at the line of scrimmage right here. Goes for the jam, Josh Jobe, and then he runs into his own man. You go for that jam and you miss, you are in trouble. Wow.
What a comeback drive. 75 yards and 5 plays. Well, only took him 90 seconds.
Josh Jobe is a skilled corner, and when you go for that physical jam at the line of scrimmage, you got to get it because all your momentum's going forward and you're beat.
don't know if they're looking maybe at whether or not Thompson
came
crossed
down
the goal line, or if he came down at inside the one.
Was his knee down before the ball crossed the plane? Boy, I think he scored.
I did too, but
catch.
It's like his upper, he's about 6'5". It looked like his upper body was across the goal line, but it's hard to tell from that angle. You know, where's the ball right there? So his elbow obviously is in the end zone.
I can tell you two guys that are hoping it's a touchdown pass, the quarterback.
Gene, what do you think? You with us?
I'm with you, guys, and I don't see anything. Here's a great angle that we get right there. And even as we see the shin and knee hit, look, the elbow at that point, I think, is crossed and broken the goal line. I don't see anything very clear and obvious to overturn that. I also was looking, because the receiver was falling initially after possessing the football,
right,
to see if he maintained control throughout the process. And I also felt like he definitely did that, too. The ball moves but doesn't hit the ground or anything. And I really don't see anything to overturn the ruling on the field after looking at these views.
You know, that's a great point, Gene, is that maybe that's what replays, making sure he survived the ground as well, because it is a big play if it was juggled from the ground. Yeah, good point. Hadn't thought of that.
Most definitely.
Perfect throw, but he's going down, so he does have to survive. And does the ball bounce back into his hands? Nope.
Well,
I can always tell when Ness knows.
After review,
he just
video
him
shows
out
that the receiver's knee was down with the ball inside the 1 yard line. It will be first and goal from inside the one.
That is a tough call to overturn that. Can't see much. I mean, that's an inch. I don't see how you could be sure to overturn that call. Man.
Yeah.
That's taking control from the replay booth, if you ask me.
I'm with you. At any rate, first and goal, inches away from the goal line. Let's see if it's KJ Jefferson. And they get the touchdown from Johnson. Dominique Johnson scores, and we don't have a signal yet.
Oh, come on.
Really? What?
Well, I think he's clearly
across by a yard.
Hey, the replay official owes him one now, doesn't he?
I don't know, but
he was clearly across the line. Even
you
Alabama
can't get any farther in there.
Even the Alabama defense thinks he's across the line.
Gee whiz.
Well, this thing's going to turn out right, in my opinion.
You want to bring Gene in this time? Seeing I'm
you're
over
doing
here,
a good
I'm
job, just, Abbott.
Yeah.
Gene, you want to weigh in again?
You know, I'm a little bit shy right now with the clear and obvious statement I made on the previous, but
hey,
I got to be honest with you guys.
Gene,
yes,
welcome. Welcome to our world.
This one appears clear and obvious that it's a score, for sure.
Okay, they just gave us the sign, Gene. Thanks.
One out of two isn't bad, guys.
Yeah, go. We're
right.
Doing the best we can here.
I know Warren Thompson's not happy with this thing.
No. Dominique Johnson makes sure, even though our officials weren't quite so clear on it. But
well, what an answer by this Arkansas football team, I'll tell you that.
That's the main thing right
yep.
now. Cam Little in for the point after. Up and good. A 75-yard drive in six plays. A little over 2 minutes to get a one-foot touchdown run. 17-14 game. Our Aflac trivia question earlier. Who's the first number one draft choice that Nick Saban had as a head coach? Dan Williams, when he was a head coach at Toledo. There's a look at Dan.
it's very tricky because Nick was there with Dan when Dan was a sophomore, and after he left, Dan ended up being a first-round pick.
Right.
Late in the season, we really look for the,
you know. We had to ask him that, and
exactly.
It took him quite a while to get the answer. We asked Nick the question, and he gave the same look he's giving to the head linesman. I'm not quite sure. I've had a lot of number one draft choice. I don't know which the number one was and who the first was. Jamison Williams.
Game clock to 3 minutes and 40 seconds, 3-4-0.
They have to reset the game clock because it didn't stop after the initial touchdown and then the second touchdown and all the confusion on that big one-yard scamper by Dominic Johnson. So we got 3:40 left in the half. Jamison Williams will field it in the end zone to take a knee. And we'll send it back to Adam Zucker in our New York studio for a Jeep update. Zuck.
Hey, Ness, no replay needed here for this snag by Mike Sainristil from number 6, Michigan. Wolverines on top of Taulia Tagovailoa and Maryland 21-3 right now, trying to set up the game with Ohio State at the Big House next week for all the Big Ten East marbles. See you in a few minutes.
All right, we'll see you at halftime, guys. 17-14, number 2, Alabama.
Wouldn't it be for half the marbles in the Big Ten? Because
I guess side? Probably. Yep. It would be that side of the marbles anyway.
Right.
Brian Johnson, what? Robinson,
whoa,
what a nice move and then a collision.
And what did Brian Robinson say to us yesterday when he bit us? When I'm running the ball, what does he like to do?
I'm going
to
hit people, not let them hit me.
Exactly. I want someone's going to get hit. It might as well be them. And he delivered the hit.
Did it on Simeon Blair. And picked up 10. 48 yards on the ground for Brian
Arkansas
Robinson.
Arkansas get out of the half.
Without any further damage.
Yep. Remember, we've seen these halves, what can happen right at the end of the half. And you can just kind of turn a game. Remember, Alabama gets the ball to start the second half. So you get a stop here. You can take a tight game, two possessions, and it's different.
Georgia put Florida away in the last two and a half minutes of the second quarter.
Yep.
Second down at 7. It's Latu, the tight end in motion. Play fake to Robinson. Young flares it out. Got it to Latu, the tight end, and he's out to midfield.
That time, Damian George, number 74, did a good job of pushing Uche outside on that play. Gets a pocket, get beat a couple times. Young player, start feeling the flow of the game.
They mark it at the 48 for the first down. Little hesitation run by Robinson, then he blasts through the middle and got 8 more. He's shown us a little bit of everything. Some speed, some power, and right here some moves.
Well, he had patience to wait for his time to come, and on this play, he had patience on the run. Took him 4 years to become the man here.
And of course, he was behind Najee Harris. That didn't help. Quick slant, Bolden. Another first down to the 32. Tied, and their offense moving briskly down the field.
George had to come out. Chris Owens, the original starting right tackle, is in the game now because the helmet came off from Damian George.
So Alabama's moved it the 2-minute mark to the 32-yard line of the Hogs. Bryce Young, and again Jamison Williams. I don't think they're going to get him. Touchdown, Alabama. Did we say quick strike? Another quick strike.
Well, this reminds you of Tua. Win at the line of scrimmage and deliver the slant pass to an elite athlete. Remember, Tua did that for all those years. A great slant passer, and that one was perfect.
Right on the money.
Yep, let him on the run.
And then it's a foot race and a little pirouette into the end zone to cap off another 75-yard drive in a hurry. Reichard's extra point is good. Bryce Young on the drive, 3 for 3. The capper, a 32-yard rocket to number 1, Jamison Williams. Crimson Tide with an answer. guys. New Tough as Nails Wednesday on CBS. That last drive of Alabama's Tough as Nails. 75 yards and six plays, and the quarterbacks, we talked about them at the top of the show, both of them playing very well today, but Bryce Young certainly not hurting his Heisman.
That should be a two, shouldn't it? Two touchdowns.
Well yeah, the one that Warren Thompson didn't catch.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay. But three touchdown passes for Bryce Young today.
Yeah, Bryce, gonna remember that picture in the open where he was kind of frowning with 33?
Yeah.
He's up to 36. It's kind of turning upward.
That's right. 36 touchdown passes, only three interceptions. Having one of those kind of seasons, it seems that way every year recently. If it wasn't Jalen Hurts, it was Tua Tagovailoa, it was Mac Jones. Now it's Bryce Young.
1:44 left. Last drive is a minute 41.
They give it to Treylon Smith out to the 30 or close to it.
And KJ Jefferson has done this early in the year against Mississippi State. He had a drive with 2 minutes to go where he was 6 for 7. Ole Miss, he had a drive where they scored the last play of the game.
That's right.
He did it. So he's used to these 2 minute drills.
They got two timeouts left, but they're not exactly in a hurry right here.
Well, you better get it right. You don't want to make a big mistake. We've seen big mistakes how turn at the end of half.
Still way too much time. Of course, unless they score here, then it's not a big deal.
Well, they can go fast now. Clock is going to stop. They're going to feel good where they are in field position and still plenty of time. Nice job inside blocking on that play. Brady Latham, number 62, comes around and rolls his man inside.
First down from the 42. And now the clock starts winding down to 55, 54. Jefferson hit in the backfield. Now rolling to throw, and he's going to throw it away. 45 seconds left before the Geico halftime report, where Adam Rook and BJ will bring you first half analysis and the best highlights from around the country. The Geico halftime report. Still 45 seconds and two timeouts.
Now you look for number 31 for Alabama. How do they help protection? Lined up on the quarterback's left side this time.
And you look for number 16, Treylon Burks, offensively, and he's in motion to the far side. Jefferson going to throw it out to his safety valve, who dropped it. Treylon Smith. He might have drawn Dallas Turner's attention over there had he caught that. I don't think he would have gotten too much out of it. Number 15.
6 or 7 yards, and he could have got out of bounds, though. You know, everything counts. But it's interesting that time Will Anderson kind of slow rushed. Didn't really go full speed. Now they shift him around.
I didn't know he had that speed.
No. To really slow him down. Now he's going to shift to the opposite side.
Empty backfield. Jefferson, quarterback draw. Broke a couple tackles, but he only got back to the line of scrimmage.
So they move him around so you can't double team. And then sometimes you loop him around. This time, Alabama coming with that blitz where they take Will Anderson and loop him around. And that's what caused the problems on the quarterback draw.
Alabama took the timeout to stop the clock with 32 seconds left and force this punt. And what was a promising start to that drive kind of fizzled. Wednesday on CBS, the legacy of the CSI crime lab is threatened, and the evidence points to one suspect. A new episode of the new series, CSI Vegas. It's Wednesday at 10, 9 central on CBS.
I know what Sam Pittman is talking to his Razorback punt team. We had a punt blocked against Georgia for a touchdown. Everybody do their assignments. We got to get this ball off. I would assume Alabama's going to kind of come up for a punt block on this one.
Yeah, Georgia did it with Jackson, the safety, blocking it, and Zamir White recovering it in the end zone in that game. Here, Reid Bauer, just get it out of there. Well, they got the return on him now. Slade Bolden camps under it and dropped it. But he covered it again around the 11. That was dangerous. Normally a sure-handed punt returner, but know if he took his eye off this one or just dropped it.
During the kick, holding on the receiving team number 28. That penalty will be enforced half the distance to the goal from the end of the kick. First down.
So it's going to put it back at about the 5-yard line as we take a look at the Dr. Pepper SEC standings. In the West, Alabama with a win today would face Georgia in the SEC championship game the first Saturday of December in Atlanta. Arkansas coming in 3-3. You realize if they had gotten the 2-point conversion against Ole Miss coming into this game, they would control their own destiny to actually win the West?
Well, Alabama's had about a normal season, but Arkansas's had a great season.
They really have.
Turning this thing around. I mean, they had a brutal schedule playing at Georgia, at LSU, at Alabama, and in a position, obviously, already bowl eligible.
They've beaten 3 ranked teams and going bowling. Brian Robinson, about 6 more to his total here in the first half.
Pretty sure both teams will be happy to go into halftime like this. And Nick Saban won't call another play.
That's the end of the first half. For Jamie's halftime interview with Coach Saban, go to Twitter at SEC on CBS. We'll send you to Adam Zucker and company in our New York studio with the Geico Halftime Report after this word from your local station. Halftime in Tuscaloosa, Alabama in front. Home Depot SEC on CBS enters quarter number 3. Bryant Denny Stadium 24-14. Brad Nestler, Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl. The carving of the turkey doesn't come till Thursday, but Bryce Young's doing a pretty good job carving up the secondary.
Yeah, both quarterbacks have played well, but remember when Bryce Young started slow, 4-for-7? I said he's going to start hitting them. Out of his next 12 passes, he had 10 for 245 yards. I mean, he threw for 287. Two good quarterbacks, one just putting up more yards. We talked about, could Arkansas get out of the half?
They didn't.
Nope, and now they need to stop badly.
And Alabama has the ball to start the third quarter as we take a look at our first half trends.
Yeah, and I think the trends will be kind of slanted toward guys catching passes. Yeah,
Metchie and Williams both over 120 receiving. Burks has been toughing it out. Has a touchdown. 35 combined points in the second quarter.
Yeah, and listen, one-third of the attempts, as we talked about, go to Metchie or Williams. Kind of understand why, right?
Yeah, exactly. They're both big plays waiting to happen. Ryan Robinson had a pretty solid first half as well. He starts things off in the backfield and with the ball in hand. Ryan Robinson for 5 more as we check in with Jamie.
Well, Sam Pittman still really frustrated with some of those easy mistakes that Arkansas made that gave Alabama points. Offensively, he felt like they were fine. Stressed the importance on gaining yards at the first down marker. Treylon Burks will still be available. He is hurting that shoulder, though. Defensively, they need to get physical with the wide receivers at the line of scrimmage.
Ryan Robinson, 4 more.
And I think that's a good point. You know, they don't have much chance once those guys get up to speed. So if you're going to stop them, you got to stop them at the line of scrimmage. But as Josh Jobe will tell you, that's dangerous sledding.
Yeah, sure is. Yes. They'd like to get a stop right here on a 3rd and 1, but they don't, as Robinson still got the legs moving.
So Bryce Young has had 3 carries in this game, but every other rushing attempt has been by Brian Robinson.
Well, we said they're shorthanded other than Trey Sanders. They got to get down to some guys that play different positions, actually, to fill in at running back because of injuries to Jason McClellan earlier and Roydell Williams. It's complete out to Latu. Latu still going down to the 33-yard line.
This was a great decision by Bryce Young. I thought he was going to go to the slot, and this ball could have been intercepted. Watch Arkansas cut underneath it, but it was going outside. And Latu makes one move and showing his athletic ability as he turns it up.
And turns it up for 30 yards. Back to Robinson. Busts through the hole. Brian Robinson, 10 more.
So in Derrick Henry's year of running the football, he carried the ball for a running back, non-quarterback runs, 70% of the time. Brian Robinson is over 55% of the rush attempts comes now from Brian Robinson. It's only going to grow, as you said. He's the guy for the rest of the year.
Here he is again, a little hesitation in the hole, picked up a couple. This is the running back story that I was just mentioning. McClellan out for the year, Roy L. Williams out for the season. Trey Sanders has come in and played a couple snaps. And then Christian Leary, a wide receiver, and DeMoy Kennedy, a linebacker, filled in at practice just in case of emergency. No emergency needed so far. Number four just stays in there and keeps carrying the rock. They fake it to him and come up firing out to Mechie. First down at the 11-yard line.
In complete control. You've got to give Bill O'Brien a lot of credit. We talked to him about the problems they had with the blitz. He says, we worked very hard on it. We think we have a good plan. So far, it's been better than good.
First down at the 11. They can get a first down at the 1. Robinson, a stop, and then is stopped. No gain. Grant Morgan, one of those rangy linebackers, in on the hit. Well, Brian Robinson was the guy in the Ole Miss game, carried it 36 times. He's got 22 right now.
And he told us that he says it almost gets lighter.
The ball gets lighter. Yeah. I don't understand.
Yeah, well,
he said depending on the situation, sometimes it can feel heavier.
Yeah, and then he goes, we heard that it's not heavy, but we never heard it gets lighter.
Right.
A lot of space off the slot right here again.
And that's Leary. The wide receiver who I mentioned has been playing some running back who was in motion. Bryce Young running out of time. And now throw sidearm out to Leary, and he'll score. Touchdown, Alabama. A little bit of everything from number 9 today.
Ness, Johnny Manziel made a play at this end of the field to have a Heisman moment. Remember, it kind of fumbled it?
Yep.
Well, this guy is in the lead for the Heisman, and this is the highlight they're going to show. Watch him run around, and then at the last second draw two defenders, and like a great point guard, just pass it off. What a play.
Another 75-yard drive, and the extra point is good. What a way to open the third quarter for the Tide. Christian Leary, his first touchdown for number 12 from 11 yards out. Tonight at 8 Eastern on CBS Sports Network, Utah State takes on the Cowboys of Wyoming. Aggies looking for their 6th straight win. 8 o'clock tonight, CBS Sports Network. Now another 75-yard drive and 9 plays. Took 3.5 minutes. Bryce Young, his 4th touchdown pass of the day. And we'll bring it out to the 25.
Ness, what do you do, okay? You're in coverage right here. You got the guy, okay? We'll put two bodies on him, and then as we go, we're just going to stay with him as he goes. All right, well, that's where he started. But now what do you do? Do I just stay, or do I go? Do I go? Oh, do I go to the quarterback? Oh, I should have stayed.
And Bryce Young at the end of this play looking like Dansby Swanson.
He was.
From the AT&T 5G pylon cam to get it out to Chris Leary, who trots in for the touchdown.
And Bryce Young, I mean, he was playing a little basketball with Jamie, and right there he was the point guard,
yep.
Right? Jamie had him, but Corey Johnson did not.
Did not. Dominique Johnson. Only about a yard gain. To'o and company fired up on the defense. Arkansas needs some points out of this thing on this drive.
Well, we said, remember, end of the half, 3:40 to go. Can they get out of the half because Alabama's going to get it, and then they're going to get it to start the second half. It goes from 17-14 to 31-14 without the football, basically.
Throw out to the tight end. Ooh. To'o put a big hit on Blake Kerr right in the back, but he's a yard and a half shy of the first down.
So if you're the Arkansas offense, you have to take, you know, a lot of positives from the first half. We moved the ball when we had time. End of the half, we didn't have time. Let's just put a drive together, put some points on the board. Still a lot of time in this football game.
Third down conversion would help the cause right here for Sam Pittman.
Got numbers at the bottom if they want to throw it to the bottom. 4-on-3.
And 1-on-1 to the top. But it's 3rd and 1, and Jefferson's going to take it under center, it appears. Nope, now he backpedals. Play clock down to 1. Got to hurry. He's going to go that way and got it complete to Burks. Burks on the run. Traylon Burks, can he make it? All the way he can. Touchdown, Arkansas.
That's a gutsy call from this Arkansas offense. Three men to the bottom. It's 3-on-2. Ness says it's 1-on-1 to the top. Do you take the easy first down throw at the bottom, or do you go 1-on-1 on the top? Hey, you need points. They're going to go back shoulder throw on 3rd and 1. And it's perfectly thrown, perfectly executed.
Then it's over, foot race.
Yeah, then it's overrun by the safety that time and all the way into the end zone. If you got a play that's a positive play, you can't turn it into a touchdown. Battle overran it.
I don't know if we've had all season long this many long scoring drives. 75 yards and 3 plays. Traylon Burks playing with a bad wing. An injured hog is a dangerous hog. 66 yards for the touchdown. Burks wheels up for 66 yards on that last scoring pass. And there was a question whether or not they got the play off in time.
Yeah, the play clock is different than the game clock. There's mechanics. I wonder if Gene could explain it to our audience.
I sure can, guys. By mechanics, the back judge who's looking at that, and yes, the offense does get a little more than what the clock shows. So when the back judge is viewing the play clock, deep middle of the defensive backfield, when the clock gets to 0, his eyes go from the play clock right to the center. If the ball is moving right at the time that he looks back down, they don't call that, and yes, it does build more than the allotted time in by less than a full second normally, and I felt like that was in that same sequence.
I did too. I thought that was reasonable, yeah, in my mind.
I know there's people that are going to disagree with that, but that's the way it's called, and yeah. Gene's explained that to us before, which is great. And just to reiterate, certainly right there on a huge play for the Arkansas offense to cut this game to 10 points again. And the pass is behind Mechie. Couldn't handle it, incomplete. So 5 minutes into the third quarter, number 2 Alabama leading number 21 Arkansas 31-21.
Are these two quarterbacks putting on a show?
Man, I guess. This has been fun to watch. 9 touchdown passes in the last 2 games. He tied his own personal best with 5 last week. He's got 4 more today. Looking for more. Brian Robinson out of the backfield.
Yeah, you don't have to always make the big, huge play that time. You got it in, nothing deep. Don't have to run. Just dump it off to your running back and make it 3rd and short. Arkansas had a stop early in the game on 3rd and short. Let's see if they can come up with another one. Bill O'Brien has just been dialing them up for this Alabama offense.
Absolutely. 3rd and 2 here. Brian Robinson switches sides to the right of Bryce Young. It doesn't look like he's comfortable with the alignment, but he's going to whip it out there to Mechie. Mechie weaving through traffic. Broke a tackle. Still on his way. John Mechie. Big first down on 3rd and short.
You know, Ness, we first heard about John Mechie when there were 3 future number 1 draft pick wide receivers in front of him. And then a 4th when Waddle joined the group. And they said, this Mechie is going to get some playing time. I go, how? Because he's good. That's how.
Another 24-yard pickup for John Mechie. Bryce Young throwing deep for Mechie. Just overshot him. Mechie broke stride just a little bit out there. Might have gotten tangled up with a corner.
1-on-1 to the outside, and Bishop goes, thankfully, it wasn't on target.
Right.
He's going to take a blow. Darius Bishop, 24, needs a rest both mentally and physically right now. Getting beat like that, you say, oh, my goodness, I survived.
2nd down and 10, at least for another down. Young. scrambles around, throws on the run, got it complete. Trey Sanders, first and goal.
Well, I'll tell you, Trey Sanders, the number two running back that's been through so much, squats to the outside and then does a great job of, at the last second, making himself available for the quarterback. Instead of just standing there, he finds open grass.
First and goal, and now he's got it with the carry to the five. Trey Sanders, as Gary said, been through a lot as a freshman. It was a foot injury, was a five-star recruit, couldn't play. Got in a car accident as a sophomore and injured his hip. He's just now getting back to the Trey Sanders that they got a scholarship to, expecting him to do big things. Did a couple big things, and he gets a pat on the backside from Coach Saban as
Absolutely.
He hit the sideline.
He's earned everybody's respect in the program the way he's kept fighting to play.
Second down and goal from the four. Bryce Young looking for number five on the day. Backpedaling. Looking for blocks. Now he runs, and he trots in for the touchdown. There's a flag down. So let's wait and see.
On the offense, number 74. 2 yard penalty from the previous spot. We will replay second down.
Yeah, it was pretty obvious when you were watching the pocket. It's Damian George that actually, you know, he's doing it right down at the bottom. He grabs a hold of, I don't know if it was needed, because as I think the style of play that Bryce Young most reminds me of is Russell Wilson when he plays. Always in control, hard to handle. I don't know if he's more dangerous in the pocket or out of the pocket.
I don't know anymore either. 406 and four touchdowns.
Yeah, he's putting on a show, but doesn't matter. He knows they need to win this game, and he needs every ounce of it because Arkansas is scoring too.
Midway point of the third quarter. Slade Bolden in motion. Throw is out. Jamison Williams will cut back inside
nice
and get
defense.
Cut down right there.
Force him inside to those linebackers. This time it was Hayden Henry, number 27, that cleaned it up.
He and Bumper Pool from those linebacker spots on this little slip screen thing, and they were waiting for it.
Hayden gets him first, and Bumper Pool, as Ness told you, cleaned it up.
Those guys are tackling machines from those
really
linebacker
are.
Spots.
They say it's a race to the ball. If you want to make a tackle, you better hurry, because the other guy's going to get there.
Third down and goal. Bryce Young looks left, looks right. Scrambles to his right, runs out of time, maybe. Yes, he will. Way back at the 30. Hayden Henry finally got him down.
That's one of those sacks that you're gonna have to talk to the head coach when you come to the sideline. I'll tell you right now, he knows it. Sometimes you gotta live with these plays, okay? He's made a lot of good ones, and this time he has one of those sacks where the quarter, watch Nick on the bottom, puts his hands up, and you're going to talk to the head coach.
Well, a loss of 16 has made it tough on his place kicker, that's for sure.
It's one of those, if you get sacked on third down and it's still a 30-yard field goal, it's not a big deal.
Right.
But when it gets back to a 45, 46-yard field goal, you're going, I hope he makes this. You need to bail me out.
Right. He's going, come on, Will Reichard, you're my best friend if you hit this thing.
Yep.
He already hit one from the same spot earlier in the ball game. And he's hit another one from that spot.
No harm, no foul. Did it get over?
It did not. My mistake. I thought he got it.
Well, now the sack is huge. It was going right down middle, and no.
Oh, hit the crossbar, and no good. So that sack is a big one. Now let's take a look at our GMC game changer here.
Well, KJ Jefferson is matching up against a tough quarterback, but he's been no slouch. Remember this play on third and long that led to a touchdown drive, and he's done it more than just in the running in the pocket. This perfect throw to the outside. You have to throw those correctly to get that back outside, and the power he always has at any time to take on anyone in the running game. Two magnificent quarterbacks in this football game.
And he's back out there right now after the missed field goal at the 29-yard line. Low snap. Jefferson handles it. Fires complete to Burks. Short game. Well, on that last drive, Alabama had it second and goal at the four. Then they had the holding penalty and a 16-yard sack. And I don't want to say that Bryce Young might have cost his team 3 points, but I think he might have cost his team 3 points because, well, I called it wrong. Reichard missed the field goal just
bit
short.
As you said, the holding penalty scores a touchdown on.
Right.
And it scrambled early for a touchdown throw to the flat. You got to live with a couple of those.
Traylon Smith taking it wide. Didn't get much out of that. Run out by Jordan Battle. Might have gotten a yard.
I mean, he knew it when he got sacked. He knew it exactly what happened. But now, you know, Arkansas's got this football. And they look at the score and go, come on, a lot has happened. We faced maybe the hottest quarterback in the country, and we're 10 points down.
That's right. And still a lot of football to go. ...50% on the third down conversions. And there's the numbers on third down passing for KJ. Third and five here. Alabama comes with an extra rusher, and it's going to pay off. Jefferson goes down.
Yeah, I think it was Will Anderson, wasn't it?
I think he was one of the first guys there, yeah.
Yeah, when you step out too wide, that's when you make the problems. When you step out wide, Will Anderson senses it and dips inside. That's the one thing you can't do. He just senses it, and he's too quick and strong.
Yep. It's going to be 13 and a half sacks for him on the season, which leads the nation. And so no harm done by the missed field goal because Bauer's going to have to punt it away. Slade Bolden on the other end has to backpedal a long ways. Nice kick to the 23 and immediately run out of bounds right there. 4:15 remaining third quarter. Alabama holding on to a 10-point lead. Now it's time for our hometown connection presented by T-Mobile. Here's Jamie.
Brad, as a six-year senior, Grant Morgan has seen it all with an Arkansas jersey on. To endure back-to-back winless SEC seasons as a walk-on, now he's a starting linebacker as a super senior on a top 25 team. It's easy to see why his contribution should be honored. This week brought news that for the second year in a row, Morgan's been named a top three finalist for the Bolesworth Award, named after former Arkansas offensive lineman Brandon Bolesworth, awarded to the most outstanding player who began his career as a walk-on.
Yeah, he's a good one. And the other two, I wouldn't want to be voting on this.
No, it's a tough one this year,
because
right?
Carlton Marshall, the Troy linebacker, and Stetson Bennett are the other guys up for that award. Former walk-ons who became stars and starters. Bryce Young, a five-star, playing like it today. His first season as a starter. Four touchdown passes today. One should have been caught by Mechie, incomplete. He's looking for his mouthpiece and the football.
So, Nessa, what do you do if you're Arkansas? Remember, Jamie said that Sam Pittman relayed to her that we need to be more physical with the receivers. Clearly, they can't cover them when they get opened up and running. Okay, so what do? Play more zone? Do you try to get them at the line of scrimmage? It's really a tough matchup when you're fearful about those guys on the wide.
Kind of darned if you do and darned if you don't.
Yeah, it really is. Hope they drop him, maybe, like that last.
Yeah, that would help, yes. Young rips it down the middle, and this one is not dropped. Jamison Williams, first down.
Yeah, so I'm watching him, Williams, go down. I think for sure he's going to go post. There's a safety in the middle of the field, and he stops and comes right back down the stem. That's what you love as a quarterback. That's trust. That's working together, because you let that ball go thinking, if he doesn't come back, I'm going to look silly here.
25-yard pickup to the 49, and another throw complete, this time to Mechie for nine more. The ball was out at the very end. I think he was down.
Yep. Oh, no, they're calling. Let's take a closer look at here what happens on this play. RPO to the outside. Are they calling it a clear fumble?
He's down.
I thought his right elbow was down.
Yep.
Maybe even his knees before that.
But wisely, Arkansas
the
picks it up.
The field is a fumble recovered by Arkansas. First down.
Oh, boy. I don't know about that one.
Now, remember, the officials are told to, if there's a doubt, call it a fumble. Well, there's no doubt in replay.
Right.
But live on the field, they lean towards fumble so the players can finish out the play. Good call by the officials on this one. Even though I think it's going to be wrong, I think it's the way to call it.
Gene Steratore is with us. Gene.
Yeah, totally agree with Gary on the play. It is wise for the officials in doubt in that scenario. Let that play in case there's a scoop and score or something like that. But I believe replay will get one look at this and see that right knee definitely down with firm possession of the football.
So Lee Hendrick is under the hood there, and Mickey Haddock will have the final call, replay official.
Now it's a big call, and as Gene pointed out, if it's a scoop and score and they called it not a fumble, they'd have to bring it back right to where the guy actually recovered the ball.
So we have been in disagreement once today with these guys. We'll see.
Does it count if when they get it wrong, but we say they got it right by getting it wrong?
I don't think everybody's going to yell at us anyway.
Well, not for a while anyway. They are. I can't hear them.
That's true. We'll hear about it later.
I avoid that stuff.
After review, video evidence shows that the runner's knee was down. It will be second down and one from the plus 42-yard line.
See how we all get along so well?
Yeah, it was really nice. So now second and very short here. Arkansas better be very careful with this play call. So look at it's second and yard, and Arkansas has three safeties 15 yards deep on this play.
They're expecting what you were expecting. And so it's Brian Robinson who heads into those safeties, and he's still banging his way down.
Well, you have to run the ball here. I mean, if it's set, you got three safeties in this situation. Look how deep. 15 yards, second and a yard. They're playing pass. You get the run. Good job by Damian George, number 74. That time, couple of tough plays, but a lot of good plays.
Quick slant, complete, and another first down. Ja'Cory Brooks that time. So everybody getting in on the act, the wide receiver core. From the 16, Young sacked.
Well, there's a misread. Was it probably a zone read for the quarterback on this play? And instead of giving it, Bryce Young tries to keep it and runs right into the blitz.
I think he's thinking he wish he would have handed it to Brian Robinson.
He sure does.
So loss of three.
Deep safeties again.
Empty backfield. Five receiver group out there for the Tide. Young pumps once. Comes complete
nice
to Williams. And bumper pool with a nice open field stop, as Gary said.
Yep, that's the object of the zone defense. You match up. You just don't cover grass. You back up in your zone. You find the guy nearest you. You anticipate the throw. And then you tackle in space.
The first down marker is at the six. That's 11 yards away. Just a three-man rush on Bryce Young over the middle. Completes it, but it's going to be well short of the first down.
You think Bryce Young said, I'm not scrambling on this one?
No, I'm not backing. I'm not backing up.
Not backing up an inch. We're getting a field goal. I can make mistakes, but I can figure out how to fix it, too.
So Will Reichert will come in. The last one was about a foot short.
Straight.
This one should be easy from 30 yards away. And it is up and good. So they did get three out of that drive. They spread the lead to 34-21.
Local.
Invesco brings you today's scholar athletes for Arkansas, Hayden Henry, the linebacker, and the quarterback for Alabama, Bryce Young. Invesco proud to support student athletes on and off the field with a donation of $1,000 to Arkansas and Alabama's general scholarship funds. After a 63-yard drive and nine plays to get the field goal, the kickoff We'll go in the end zone. We'll bring it out to the 25, and we'll send it out to our New York studio for a Jeep update. Here's Adam Zucker.
Yeah, Ness, and Braylon Allen can go meet me, too. He had his seventh straight 100-yard game in the first quarter for Wisconsin. His second touchdown puts the Badgers back on top of Nebraska as they try to keep the edge for the Big Ten West. Seven-point game in the fourth quarter. Keep it posted.
Good one. Keep us posted, Zuck. Thanks. Here it's a 13-point Alabama lead with 109 to go, third quarter.
Yeah, I mean, Alabama's got 500 and almost 50 yards, but it's a 13-point game. I think late in the third quarter, I'm liking my chances if I'm Arkansas. Staying in the game.
K.J. Jefferson on a quarterback draw. Runs into To'o again. Those two have introduced each other several times today. That's a three-yard gain. Time of possession, 5 minutes more for Alabama. As Gary said, 5:41 in total offense. And here's a tough run by A.J. Green, who hasn't seen a lot of time in the backfield.
Right. They got, on this team, five different players have led the team in rush attempts over different games. They got a lot of guys that carry the football.
And To'o pulling and tugging, and even with that, it's a first down run. Nice effort by A.J. Green, and that might bring the third quarter to a close unless they get another snap in. Looks like they will.
Well, Kendall Byers, the offensive coordinator for Arkansas, his theory is we always got time for one more play.
Always time. Going to have to hustle, though.
Now, he's going to go to the fourth quarter, still in the football game.
That brings the third quarter to a close. Good game here in the SEC West. Second-ranked Alabama hoping to win at home and set themselves up for the Iron Bowl and then the SEC Championship. Still a quarter to go, though. The light show at the end of the third quarter, heading into the fourth quarter on the Home Depot SEC on CBS. Alabama at home, where they've won 60 of their last 62 games. And they've got a 13-point lead heading into the final stanza. K.J. Jefferson and company with a first down at their own 36-yard line. Little flip to Burks, trying to get wide and can't. Picks up about 3 yards. Welcome you back to the booth, Brad and Gary. You know, we showed that stat, 60 of the last 62, but Arkansas is not going away here.
No, but my thought was, how much fun could this be playing football if you're Arkansas? Where you were the last couple of years, you're playing against a great football team. Alabama's offense is going to put points on everybody, but it's a fight. It's a fight to the finish. We know Alabama's one of the best teams in the country. Can they finish off this Arkansas team that plays really hard?
Jefferson lobbing one.
That was
incomplete. Raheem Sanders, as we check in with Jamie.
Well, Sam Pittman turned around and challenged the offensive line before this series started. He said, guys, we're two scores away. If you keep pushing to get those first downs, we can steamroll these guys. He's really focused on this one drive in the trenches.
They're going to need six right here to keep the drive going.
Especially with that defense holding Alabama out of the end zone the last two times they were down there, keeping it a game.
This is where you go, where's Will Anderson?
Yeah, I was just going to circle when we got the shot. Here's the matchup right here. They run the stunt again.
Jefferson going deep. Burks has got it. First down.
So it takes just a little bit longer to run the stunt and get there. And Burks, who's been playing with an injury to his right shoulder the whole game, or right pec, goes up and makes another outstanding play. This time, was it Kool-Aid McKenzie that's in there?
It is.
Number one, yes.
It hits the deck hard on that shoulder after a 27-yard pickup. He's going to trot off. Boy, this guy's playing on some guts today.
Absolutely. NFL scouts will love his ability and also love the fact that he will play hurt.
First down at the 33. A minute into the fourth quarter. A.J. Jefferson on third down has been sensational throwing the football. Let's see how he does on first down. Crowd making it hard on the offense right now. They'll keep it on the ground. Maybe a yard. Will Anderson draped all over Raheem Sanders.
Well, tenacious. That's the word that comes out. He never stops playing. Coach Saban told us yesterday, we asked, who's the alpha dogs?
He's the one.
He's the one.
There wasn't even any hesitation when we asked him that. He said, number 31. And he has used that alpha dog status a few times this year to challenge his teammates to play to the Alabama standard that they're used to around here. And he's got his teammates' attention. That one's tipped, but still caught. And really close to a first down for Trey Knox.
That's that hybrid wide receiver tight end. He lines up in a tight end position. It's RPO, and it was tapped by Turner that time. Dallas Turner, but not enough.
And now let's see if they have enough for the first down. Flag
down.
Start
on the offense, yeah. Number 84.
That'll drive the coach crazy. When you go hurry up, you don't want to go so fast that you go too fast for your own lineup and you make a mistake.
They call it on Warren Thompson, I think. Oh, yeah, he was backpedaling down there at the bottom.
Yep. And that's part the quarterback. You got to look around and make sure everybody's set, too.
So now, third down and six instead of third and one.
Now you wonder, from this part of the field, does Kendall Briers think four down territory with this call?
Jefferson keeps it, but doesn't get much. Maybe three. Dallas Turner again and on the hit.
He did a great job. Now inside, those guys kind of make a pile, but Dallas Turner plays his assignment.
You might have read Sam Pittman's lips. He just said, go for it.
You could almost tell from that play call that Kendall Briers knew he was going to go for it on fourth down.
Fourth down, and it's more like four than three. Biggest play of the game so far for both teams.
Oh, another mistake.
And another flag.
Ball start and the offense, number 62.
I don't think Stromberg, number 51, heard the snap count that time. That's where you got to have that silent count. If you depend on the center to hear the clap, because he didn't hear it.
Well, that's because there's about 105,000 people screaming, and he didn't hear it. And that'll change things now. They'll bring out Cam Little. He's been money this year for a freshman.
Well, I wonder if this is into the wind a little bit. It doesn't look like a lot of wind, but that one last one was short by Alabama.
From 50 for Little. And it's a fake, and it's a jump pass, and it's caught by Kern, and he's going to score. Touchdown, Arkansas. Are you kidding me?
What a play. What a catch. Look at Sam.
There's the smiling Sam we talked about earlier. Wow. Reed Bauer, the putter.
And our camera was on. It was right as if you were throwing it on that last play when we were going live. You could see him reach back and make the play. How about here? This one's almost as if you're doing it yourself. Reaches back, tips it to himself, and goes. What a play.
Second touchdown reception of the year for the tight end Kern on a great catch and another 75-yard drive. How many of those have we had today? Extra point is up and good. On a fourth down and long. Check it out again.
You don't think they did those penalties on purpose, do you?
Just for a longer reception.
Touchdown, Alabama. We burst at the touchdown.
I don't think they're going to get him. Touchdown, Alabama. A look at our Ally game recap. This has been something to watch. Bryce Young putting on a show at quarterback for Alabama. Burks, the wide receiver, playing with a bad shoulder and arm. Metchie and Williams have had over 300 yards, and then this.
The number three quarterback comes in with a jump pass. Not perfect, but good enough, huh? That was a nice catch.
On fourth down, and so we got a one-possession game, folks, with 11:24 to go.
Just thinking back, 3 weeks ago, Ness, we were traveling and watching the Tennessee-Alabama game. Remember, Tennessee scored early in the fourth quarter, a 70-yard pass. Alabama came back and answered with three touchdowns to pull away. Challenge again.
Yep. Not for the faint of heart right now. So Alabama comes out to the 25. Big holiday weekend of college football coming your way next week. This week, I should say. Starts on Friday at noon with Mountain West matchup between Boise State and San Diego State, followed by Missouri matching up with these Razorbacks on Saturday. And then on Saturday, we'll get you started. The drive to Atlanta and State Farm College football today. Then at 3:30 Eastern, SEC on CBS brings you another chapter of the Iron Bowl. These Crimson Tide of Alabama heading to Auburn to the Plains, take on the Tigers. It's all coming up this coming week right here on CBS. Boy, I don't know if any of the games are going to be as good as this one has been. We hope so. Young fires. Slade Bolden.
In the slot again. And you say fires, it was. He knew it right away. Slade Bolden goes right past the safety in the slot and takes it, knows he's going to get hit, wraps it up, stands up and goes, yep, that's me.
27-yard strike. And now it's Brian Robinson. No gain on this one. Hayden Henry. And on the stop. Single season, single game record, I should say. You think about all just the last 5 years, well, all the great quarterbacks here.
And he's got to go over 500 to win the game, I think.
Absolutely.
Right?
He's going to throw it right here, too. They don't have a lot of design runs for him, and it's an empty backfield. Well, maybe he will run. And he got the first down.
Well, he knew he was safe. Again, three-man rush. That's the tough thing about a three-man rush. Arkansas is built for a three-man rush team. When you get these kind of quarterbacks and give them those space like that, you know, the type of scramblers like Bryce Young, it's tough to handle.
5 minutes into the quarter, a 16-yard scramble by Young.
We talked about Barry Odom. What do you do? What do you do? Can't really cover him. Can you rush him?
Now the RPO, he's going to go right back to the guy he faked it to, Brian Robinson, who bobbled the ball, caught it a second time, picked up six or seven on this senior day for this senior who's waited his turn with some great backs in front of him. Najee Harris came in the same class.
You know, he told us one that transferred away, Cam Akers, was in the same signing
right,
class.
Florida State.
And then Cam kind of reneged on his thing.
Pretty good group, huh?
Yeah.
Here he is again. And he's got another first down.
Well, what do you want to see him do over again? Because he has been magical. Back shoulder throws, scrambling all around, hitting guys with the RPOs or the slants, and then playing point guard from the quarterback position for the touchdown. One negative play, the sack. Coach got with it.
Yeah, that's right. Almost had a sack there. This one he threw away and got rid of it.
And he did it at the last second because he knew that if he didn't throw it right away, Nick would be putting up his arms again going, we don't need a sack right here.
Scott Hunter, one of the honorary captains today at the stadium, 484. Bryce Young just passed him. And Mac Jones carved up the Falcons on Thursday night. So that's pretty good company.
Yeah. Again, putting the running back out there, you know it's going to be zone because they bumped a corner on the running back. Drop in zone. Yep.
And he drops it to the tight end, Latu. Still going. He lost the ball, and it's covered by Arkansas. Fumbled and picked up by Brown at the one. Looked like it was going to be another touchdown pass, and instead it's a fumble.
You know what zone? Hit him quickly in the zone right there. Latu going, struggling, and they rip it through and rip it off. I think it was Brown. Tarek Brown, number 21, that rips it out.
He covered it, too.
Yes, he did.
Arkansas with the ball and a chance to take the lead when we come back. Here we are in the fourth quarter. We've had a lot of great plays in this game, but later, the play of the game presented by Jersey Mike Subs. Gary just said, I don't think we've seen the play of the game yet.
No, something's going to happen. Listen, Arkansas has already had a 96-yard touchdown drive in the game. This will top that if they do it.
They start at the one with K.J. Jefferson in the backfield with Traylon Smith. It's Smith, and he got it out around the five. Team straight losses. Their last win, Nick Saban wasn't the coach then. Mike Shula was.
Well, they came close in 14. Remember that 14-13 game? That was the closest. Otherwise, they've all been two-score games at least.
And Smith wrapped up after about a yard gain. And it's going to bring up a huge third down right here.
So this offense has been carrying this Alabama football team basically all season. That's been the football team. Now, can the defense step up and do their job right now? We got a team backed up. Now, wasn't backed up because of a punt. It was a mistake. But can this Alabama offense, excuse me, defense, get a stop here?
Third down and five. Jefferson coming up, trying to be heard with his offensive line, and they're going to call timeout. So we'll take one with them. 7:42 remaining in the fourth quarter. Number two, Alabama, clinging to a six-point lead. You can... Tomorrow, Queen Latifah returns in The Equalizer, show the critics are calling fresh and reinvigorating. Don't miss a new episode of The Equalizer tomorrow after 60 minutes on CBS. Arkansas hoping for an equalizer. A touchdown would tie it. An extra point would give them a lead over the number two team in the country. And Sam Pittman said after a four-game winning streak to start the season, then losing three in a row, he said, let's get the four B's, fellas. Bowl eligible, the Boot Trophy over LSU, beat Bama, and then the Battle Line Trophy against Mizzou. Well, he's got three. He's got the third B in order right now. But
it's doable still, right? They're still in charge and making it happen. Nice goal. Nice way to build a program.
And they got the bowling ball, Larry, their bowling ball in their locker room. But they need five here. Jefferson, no, incomplete. And Nick Saban saying that Thompson pushed off.
So remember on third down prior, they did the same thing, a back shoulder throw. And this time Armour Davis does a good enough job that it had to be too good of a throw, and it could not be handled by Warren Thompson.
So Blade Bolden back at midfield, as the punt's going to have to come from the end zone for Bauer.
Just want to say the Alabama defense did get their stop. We challenged them, and they did it.
Bolden, fair catch, taken around the 45. So 7.5 minutes, midway, fourth quarter. Alabama's got it back, and a 34-28 lead. Going to be a fantastic finish. Don't go anywhere. Just playing Wisconsin football right there. And reminder, just having heard from Zuck, coming up, college football post-game show presented by Rocket Mortgage. Adam, Rick, and BJ bring you the highlights of all the games, including this one.
Funny you say that, Wisconsin football. You would think Alabama football used to be run the ball here.
And they're going to run it with Brian Robinson for about 13 yards.
You could always depend on, you know, Melvin Ingram, you know, Ingram or Trent Richardson or Derrick Henry. You know, they were going to carry the ball. But now, number nine is so good. I mean, do you take the ball out of his hands?
Brian Robinson putting on a senior day show. 123 yards on 26 carries. I don't know if it's getting lighter or not.
Yeah, see, here's what happened. Those linebackers get those tackle for losses. Now you're a little bit behind the chains. If you don't win on first down, it goes back to the quarterback on second down.
Record-setting day. 515 yards throwing the football. Four touchdowns. And he's not done yet.
Here's the formation they've settled on. Put the running back to the bottom of the field. Declare whether it's zone or man. It's zone. You know what you got.
Over the middle. Yep. Got a strike complete to Mechie.
When you, everybody knows it's zone. Once the corner walks out with the running back, the receivers know instead of crossing the field, they find a little bubble and they sit down. Everybody's on the same page.
It has been a while since Arkansas has beaten a top five team. And it's been even longer since they've beaten Alabama.
Here they come. Oh, got him.
False start on the offense, number 55. That's a five-yard penalty.
The man, Ikiar.
Third down.
And now it's third down and a long one.
55 Ikiar right there. Bah, he feels the blitz. He feels the blitz and too much.
So now it's third down and 10. Clock will work its way under 6 minutes. Best third down conversion team in the SEC. Can they pick one up here? Three-man rush. Young loads it. Rips it long. Touchdown. Jameson Williams.
Boy, what a read by Bryce Young. Bill O'Brien said Bryce Young might be the best I ever had at seeing the open guys because he's so small. At the beginning of this play, what a job, what a catch. I thought there was a free safety in the middle of the field. They go, no way he's going to go deep. But he stayed with the play. He knows it's just a three-man rush when he sees those linebackers leave, and he stays with it.
A touchdown. That play is under review.
Here's another look. You see him airing it out long. I waited forever to say touchdown because I was waiting for the back judge to give me something.
Remember,
here's another look at the end of the play.
And remember, it's third and long, so they should take a good look at this.
Gene Steratore is going to join us. Gene, what do you think?
Really, really close play, guys. And this is another play like the previous where you have a receiver going to the ground. He needs to survive the ground with possession of the football. The reverse angle look that we got, in my opinion, he has possession of the ball. Yes, it starts to move as he is falling, but I don't see him losing control of that ball. When it moves here as he begins to land, the right hand gets underneath of the football, or the left does, I'm sorry, and cradles it from hitting the ground. And I believe there is still possession there with that left hand underneath. Then the right hand on the nose, and he's controlling that. And I have that as a catch and a stands or confirm of the ruling on the field.
That's fantastic explanation there, Gene. The knee, the feet were in, the knees were in, then you got to see if there's more than just touching the ground. Does the ball move enough?
So again, we'll go to the replay official up here. Meanwhile, Bryce Young just waiting to see if that's his
and remember,
fifth
if
touchdown
it's,
pass.
If it's overruled, it's most likely going to be a punt. They're out of field goal range with that illegal procedure penalty.
This one's taking a while. And it should, because it's very, very important. Here's a call.
After the review, ruling on the field stands, touchdown.
So a great job First of all, three-man rush, so Bryce knows he has time to throw the ball. The free safety actually comes out of the middle of the field to go for the crossing route, and then he goes right over his head, and then Jameis does a great job of handling that ball. Jameson does a great job, and of course, with the score as it is, they're going to go for two. Get it to 14.
Well, they might need it to be to 14, the way this game's gone. From the three.
I've seen
a group of four comes out to the bottom of the screen.
Seen him go quarterback draw with this look.
That's what's going to happen, and he got it. Bryce Young doing it all today.
So it was actually an RPO with a quarterback draw connected to it. The quarterback can look down. The guard is playing run. The quarterback can throw it early or run late.
Might be a Heisman handshake right there.
Don't be
shattering the school single game record today. Bryce Young with 561 yards passing.
Ness, when I, between the time I threw 561 yards, I had two kids. Took me 2 years to do that.
Christy was waiting on those 561 yards through two children. And this guy, what a game, tying his own single season school record as well with five touchdown passes, 10 in the last 2 weeks.
And we said he's going to need every one of those yards because this Arkansas team went toe to toe with him. Still time.
Yep. So that's on the shoulders of KJ Jefferson.
But it's probably the time of the game you're thinking, if we, unless we score real fast, it will probably be touchdown onside kick situation.
Traylon Burks is in a slot to the left. He's been his big play receiver. He flares it out to A.J. Green. Green's got some space. And then got leveled out of bounds by Branch.
And Pete Golding, defensive coordinator, told us that Brian Branch might be the most physical of his defenders. He's going to play a lot of football. They like to put him into the boundary side of the field. You saw it right there. There's Pete.
Second down and two. Approaching the five-minute mark. Jefferson lobs it out to Green again. And I don't think he got there, but pretty close. Will Anderson tossed him down.
Yeah, Big Phil, 48. Number two, Mathis, comes out there. Defensive tackle. The juice is in this Alabama defense right now.
He did get the first down. I wasn't sure, but right, apparently right there, because they've already moved the sticks at the 35. Precious seconds ticking off for Arkansas. KJ Jefferson loads it, fires near side, intended for Warren Thompson, incomplete. What's at stake, you're asking, as you look at Bryce Young? A trip to Atlanta to meet Georgia, that's what's at stake. A West Division title will be won today if they can hold off the Razorbacks.
And Alabama knows to get there with just one loss, so that way that committee can't do anything if you win the game. No decision if you win.
They're going to keep it on the ground here. I don't know about that, but no game for Smith.
Well, unless it's a quarterback draw, you might have seen the last running back carry the ball in a run play.
Third down and 10. Got to get to midfield. Kendall Briles, the offensive coordinator, knows it. So does KJ Jefferson. And a sellout crowd at Bryant Denny.
One-on-one to the top.
And it is a quarterback draw, and it goes nowhere.
Guess who?
Will Anderson.
Good guess. Educated guess. Go with the odds. Four-man look over there. Quarterback draw. Matched up against Dalton Wagner, and I've seen players like that before. It gives you nightmares.
I personally think there might be two Alabama players in New York for the Heisman presentation.
Yeah,
that's how much I think of Will Anderson.
I question why they're punting here. Really got to wonder why. I think Sam's going to think this over and go for it.
Sam Pittman. That's going to be their second timeout, too.
And remember, he went for two for the win against Ole Miss, and the Arkansas fans loved it.
Now Sam Pittman took that timeout, and it might be a wasted one because I got to think he's going to put his offense back on the field having thought it over. He might not see the ball again.
He had to rethink it out. I don't know if it's going to be wasted if it works. I mean,
right. You
would not like to do it, but you had to. He looked it up at the clock, go, what am I doing here?
Fourth and ball game, probably. Jefferson. Down the middle, got it. Complete and a first down. Trey Knox, so it was worth it.
Well, he had time to throw, and that means Wagner out here did a good job on Will Anderson. Kept him off his quarterback and allowed the long pass to be completed.
Pick up a 15 and a first down, and now pressure. Anderson almost had Jefferson, and now Ta'o does.
So block me once. Okay, this time I'm going to use my speed and get to the outside. Watch him come around. Actually, that time it was inside with Christian Harris. That on the stunt that time that flashed him, and Ta'o cleans it up. Good call by Pete Golding that time, changing up the rush look.
Under 2.5 minutes. Second and 15. There's a running play, and I'm not quite sure about that one.
Guess
Christian
who it is
Harris.
Again, back-to-back plays by Christian Harris. Been playing since he was a true freshman, grown into the position, to be more athletic this year with Ta'o calling out the signals.
Semi-finalist for the Butkus Award, made a big play there. We're down under 2 minutes. Jefferson steps up. Fires far side. What a catch.
Did he survive it?
Treylon Burks, who's caught just about everything thrown his way today.
Might be interference before he caught it.
Wow. Well, I mean, it comes out there, but.
Yep. I don't know who they're calling. If it's an offense or defensive pass
interference. Interference on the defense, yeah. Number 14. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot.
That's who it was on. And that's who was covering Burks on the play. Brian Branch. Just as the ball's coming.
I don't know.
I know. That was from that angle. From the other angle, I thought he did. From that angle, I didn't see anything.
Might have had his right hand on his hip a little bit. At any rate, it's an all-important first down for the Razorbacks. 1:50 left. One timeout left. At the 42 of Alabama. Needing two scores. KJ Jefferson lobs it on the run. Complete again to Knox. And he's knocked down at the 35. Got a hustle here.
Great job by Wagner coming off his man and blocking the free safety on the play. Branch.
Second and three. And this time the running play does work. Raheem Sanders down to the 22-yard line. Clock stopped momentarily with 1:19. They'll run it again with Sanders. He gets to the 16.
Maybe timeout by Arkansas right here. Yeah, I think that's a good timeout right there.
Minute 5. Sam Pittman in his second year for Arkansas comes in at 7-3, as we said, started off 4-0, then they hit a losing skid, and then they put three more wins together to get to this point.
And you can't say 7-3 without putting Arkansas into perspective of what happened before he came to this program. You know, 2 years in the SEC, just futile. And they came in a slight turn last year, and this year it's full speed ahead for this Arkansas program. Said he felt good about his football team competing. You know, he said, in the Georgia game, I was just kind of yelling at him to stop him, stop him. Now I've told my coaches, tell them how to stop him.
Exactly.
Or how to move the ball.
Well, in 18 and 19, there were no SEC wins. Last year in an all-SEC season, it was 3-7. And now this year at 7-3, they know they're going to a bowl game. And they've got Missouri on Friday, right here on CBS. And they've had Alabama's attention all day long.
Over 1,100 yards of total offense.
107 to go. No timeouts anymore. Jefferson to the corner of the end zone. Caught for the touchdown by Sanders.
Gotta love it. A running back out there going with a back. Well, it's actually a fade is what it is. You got a linebacker on a running back. You might as well go to it. And he turns around and handles it.
This is a heck of a catch.
Absolutely. When your wide receivers make plays like that, you're happy. When your running backs do it, you go, man.
17-yard touchdown pass. Caps off another, you guessed it, 75-yard scoring march in 12 plays.
You know, I did not notice him out there matched up against the linebacker. And it didn't matter whether I noticed it, K.J. Jefferson noticed it.
That's right. So the extra point coming up. And now they're going to go and look at the last play again. And a busy review group today.
Gene is going to ask for a raise if we go one more time.
Yeah. 102 to go. And the play under review was ruled a touchdown. You take a look at Sanders getting his arms under it. Dan Jean's with us as he earns that raise.
It's good to be back with you guys in another tight play, another going to the ground situation. Sanders he firmly secures the football with both hands, goes to the ground. I believe that when he is down and falling to the ground, even though the ball is not secured with both hands, it's sitting in the left arm. The ball lands on that left forearm, and it's still firmly controlled. In my opinion, I don't believe the ground helps him at all. This is a great angle. If you watch that one, it loses it a little. The other reverse we had, I think, shows that he firmly controls it through that process, and I don't see any reason not to keep this a touchdown.
This is the one Gene was talking about, the best look. He's about to lose it, but he keeps his right hand
right
on it. Just enough, his right hand. Oh, we got pylons everywhere.
We got AT&T pylon camps here.
We got, how many of them? Four of them?
Yeah, that one shows the paint on the back of this jersey better than anything else.
I think we had the look and big play. Hey, there's nowhere to go, right?
No timeouts left for Arkansas. An important extra point coming up, and then an onside kick is what we anticipate, as Gary said earlier.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Boy, what a couple of shows these quarterbacks have put on.
Absolutely.
Man. 325 yards throwing for K.J. Jefferson and three touchdowns. 561 yards passing for Bryce Young. And five touchdowns.
1,100 yards of total offense. Got
Cam Little. Point after. It's good. So here we go. Gonna come down to one play probably when we come back. It'll be an onside kick. If Alabama gets it, they're the West champs. Otherwise, we're gonna have some kind of finish. Back at Bryant-Denny Stadium, a lot of fireworks here today. And now one more firework coming up, an onside kick, and the good hands team out there for the Crimson Tide. Cam Little, the freshman, set up to go to his left. And that's where it goes. Takes a big hop and goes out of bounds. And that will pretty much do it. Well, it took a bounce that he wanted, but it too high and out of bounds.
There won't be
a kick out of bounds on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty where the ball went out of bounds. First down, Alabama.
So it'll be a knee to finish the game. They only need two of them.
Yep.
Every Arkansas fan who's watched this game is going to go out tonight and say, we played our ass.
Butts off, yeah.
You got it. Right? Did I say ass?
I think you did. Well, it's okay. The same part of the body.
Well, but you're not allowed to say that. That's all.
Well, that's up to you.
I know.
I'm just going to keep my distance from you now for the next two seconds. I think the Arkansas fans understand what you're talking about. What an effort by the Razorbacks, and what a performance by number 9. It looked like he wanted to shake the ref's hand there.
or maybe the ref wanted to shake his hand.
Can I get an autograph?
Yes.
Quarterback comparison was something we were just talking about a minute ago. Look at those numbers. And no interceptions. 8 touchdowns between the two of them.
Yeah, and remember, KJ could have had 4 very easily, right?
Yep.
Over on the bench, the player was hurt as he went. I don't know if it was a player on the sideline or one of the players that was running. Yeah.
I guess somebody on the onside kick team.
Oh, it's Treylon Burks again.
Is it Burks?
Yep.
And then some coaches go down
and
over there, too.
It was Will Anderson who blocked them, by the way. Watch Will Anderson. He's got a guy at the front line blocks.
Whew.
And he did his job.
Well, Treylon Burks has been a trooper all day today, man. He's played hurt, and he's hurt again. A brilliant performance.
Brilliant performance.
And there's knee number 1.
Well, I can tell you this. In Nick Saban's post-game press conference, he will show the respect that the Arkansas team deserves, and his team answered it. His defense answered that one down at the back, and the game never ended. Neither team took a step back in this football game.
This will be 15 straight Alabama over Arkansas, but boy, do they have to work for it. And now Alabama will go to 10-1, 6-1 in the conference, and the West Division champions of the SEC. And they're one more hurdle away from a gigantic matchup with Georgia and Atlanta. We know they're going to play them. Will they still be number 1 and number 2? It'll be an epic battle if indeed that's the case. So here's how the standings look. Georgia's perfect at 11-0. Only one blemish on Alabama's record. That was on a last-second field goal and a loss to Texas A&M. But East and West, we know who's going to play now in Atlanta. And Jamie's with a winning coach.
Coach, congratulations with that win. You're going to the SEC championship, but today was not easy. What was the most important part of this win?
Well, I think that it was a win, so we're happy about that. We didn't play great on defense, which is an issue we got to get resolved. And we didn't finish drives in the red zone, which is another issue. You know, we fumble the ball on the 2-yard line, we take a sack, we miss a field goal. So we did a lot of things, gave them a fake field goal for a touchdown. So there's a lot of things that we can correct. All right, but look, these guys have played hard all year long. It's tough in the SEC, and it's tough in the West. So I knew they had a good team, and I knew this was going to be a tough game. So I'm proud of our players for the way they competed and how they finished.
Congratulations, Coach.
All right, thank you. Appreciate it.
And now it's time for the play of the game, presented by Jersey Mike Subs. And of the many, many things done so well by Bryce Young, this one was the capper, a 40-yard touchdown strike to Jamison Williams. This is how Eli Gold called it on the Alabama Radio Network.
Bryce, high snap, gets it. Evan Neal picks up the blitz, long throw, Jamison Williams, touchdown Alabama! Jamison Williams, touchdown 40 yards. He beat the defense like a blur.
And that was touchdown number 5 for Bryce Young and secured the win for the Crimson Tide. That's going to wrap it up for Gary Danielson, Jamie Erdahl, Gene Steratore, and our entire CBS crew. Brad Nessler saying so long from Tuscaloosa, where the Crimson Tide win it at home. We'll get you back to Adam Zucker and company for the college football postgame show presented by Rocket Mortgage right after these messages. See you at Auburn next Saturday.